Hello and welcome to beautiful Tokyo and the Mount Fuji International Speedway hosting the men's individual time trial. 39 riders, 31 nations represented. They'll be taken to the start tram for what is regarded as the ultimate test in cycling, and it really is today. Temperature around 25 degrees, humidity at 70%. It will feel a lot warmer than that out there under these clouds. With that humidity, possibility of a little bit of rain later on as well as the riders head out onto this course. 44 kilometers of riding. Tom Dumoulin, former world champion, all smiles, the Dutch, and they are looking for some redemption here after disappointment in the road race, and he carries their hopes. A man who has not raced much this year, but he will no doubt be hoping he goes well today. This is Shahid Safradzin of Iran. And he will be our second rider off the start ramp. So the Fuji International Speedway hosts men's individual time trial at Tokyo's Summer Olympics of 2020. And a champion in the making today, no question about that. Three world champions on the start list, four Grand Tour winners, and a host of national champions. So we'll be bidding to become the Olympic champion this year. Who will the course suit best? Well, we'll find out. It is hilly. There's 840 meters of climbing on this 44 kilometer course, starting and finishing at the Fuji International Speedway. Host of four Formula One races in 1970 and 2000. They do a short loop and then they head out on the R51 road past two golf courses, a 5 kilometer climb. And then that is the first of those time checks on the first lap. That comes at 9.7 kilometers, the second of them at 15 kilometers. They head onto the racetrack, do a full lap of what is a fairly undulating track, and they'll do one more lap to complete the 44.2 kilometers. So this is the start list of 39 riders, and they are ranked in start order in the order in which they are ranked on the UCI rankings. Teo Gegenhardt, a Giro d'Italia winner, Richie Porte, well, redemption for him. He's looking for, he didn't ride the time trial in Rio. Rigoberto Urán in his fourth Olympic Games, a silver medalist on the road, of course, in London. Atleti Lutsenko, Brandon McNulty had a great road race, and he could be a man to figure here. Down to the business end, Filippo Ganna, the world champion. Wout van Aert, many people's favorite, the Belgian. Stefan Kung, the Swiss rider who went so well in the Tour de France, and the former French champion, Remy Cavagna. Eritrea represented today by Aminul Gebregazebir. South Africa's Stefan de Bocht. In his first Olympics, he replaced Daryl Impey, who had a crash and broke his collarbone, couldn't recover in time. So de Bocht rode the road race, and he will go in the time trial today. Algeria's Azzedine Lagab. And well, this young man has shown in the road race that he's a real contender. Brandon McNulty, he will go in a while still. So the start ramp is positioned pretty much just before the exit of the pits in a Formula One sense. The riders will leave at 90-second intervals and head off on the two laps of what is a very, very tough course. 44.2 kilometers and 846 meters of climbing. First time Olympian. Ahmed Badreddin Weiss gets the men's individual time trial underway. He's a first-time Olympian, and he's one of 29 refugee athletes granted a quoted place in the Olympic Games this year. The only one in the time trial. He was 55th at the World Championships in 2020, and he is the pathfinder on this time trial. Alongside me, watching for the next couple of hours in this enthralling battle of wits, mental and physical strength, is Rochelle Gilmore.
Yes, thank you, Gerald. I'm very excited today about seeing what Rohan Dennis can do. The course suits him. He pulled out of the road race to be ready for this time trial. But Wout van Aert, also a fan's favourite, so be delighted to see what he can do as well.
Yeah, we've got many. Philippe Bogan, Wout van Aert, and Remco Evenepoel, the young Belgian. They have two cards to play there. And Rohan Dennis, well, he's got plenty to prove after his disappointment in Rio when he broke a ski and finished fifth despite that. So he'll be focused here. Primoz Roglic, Kasper Asgreen, Geraint Thomas, perhaps. He'll have to do something special today. Patrick Bevan from New Zealand is an outsider. The 2019 Iranian national champion. He didn't finish the road race a couple of days ago. But he is the Iranian national champion on the road the last couple of years. And all the nerves will be put to rest now. The build-up to these events, there's nothing like a time trial there in cycling. All other races, you're in a bunch and there are other riders around you. This, though, tests every single aspect of a rider's makeup. Really does put you to the test.
Yeah, certainly a race of truth. And as we can see, the men, they're rolling out a little bit more calm, the earlier riders, than we saw in the women's with the aggression of Annemiek van Vleuten. Their race, admittedly, is a little bit shorter, of course, but right from the gun, it takes a lot of high speed to try and win the time trial at this level, the Olympic Games.
Any technical little start as they go through a few corners, and then after 4 kilometres, they hit the climb. And it's a tough climb, nearly 200 meters of climbing. The Algerian national champion, he was fourth at the All Africa Games time trial in the 2019. Azzedine Lagab. And he heads off now to challenge himself and put a time on the clock.
Well, it always amazes me when we see riders racing with a beard, how technical the sport is when it comes to aerodynamics and that frontal surface area and shaved legs, all the gear, and then a little bit of hair on the face, even in these hot conditions here in Tokyo.
So away goes the Algerian Lagab, seven-time national champion, and an opportunity to ride in the Olympic Games. What a rare privilege. Something he has experienced before, as he did go to the Games in London, where he failed to finish the road race. Second opportunity here in Tokyo. Full-time rider on the world tour. Emmanuel Gebregazabir from Eritrea, three-time Giro d'Italia finisher, and he's completed the Vuelta as well. He did the Giro earlier this year, following in the footsteps of the great Daniel Tekla Heinemann, Mehawi Kudus, Natnel Bahani. Great legacy being built up in Eritrea. The 2019 time trial champion Gezak Bibir is on the road. So the first mark we'll be looking for is at 9.7 kilometers, which is on the climb towards the top part of the 5 kilometer climb, which, as I said, takes the riders from an altitude of 455 meters up to 676 over 5 kilometers. Average gradient of 4.5%, but it does get a lot steeper near the top. Wide lines being taken here. In the full skin suit, lines for the Trek Segafredo World Tour team, as I said, he was at the Giro d'Italia this year. Seconds is the time margin. Niki Hassan from Germany. Goes back to 2015 when he went really well in the World Championships. He finished fifth there, the 29-year-old. And he's on his route now to try and put a marker on. One of two Germans in the field, Max Schuckmann, will go a little later, but aren't perhaps a better option in terms of the time trial. Maybe wondering how riders qualified to ride at the time trial. There were 40 quota spots available. First 30 assigned through world rankings to the nations. One place per nation. As long as each continent had at least two places. Another 10 places assigned through the 2019 World Championships. Again, with a limit of one place per Olympic Committee. Could earn two places by qualifying in both ways. That's through the rankings and the World Championships. And all 10 of those places, the World Championships, were earned by nations with riders inside the top rankings. So that's why nations like Germany have two riders in the field. The refugee Olympic team, and we've seen Ahmed Weiss out on the course. They were granted a position as well. Of course, these rankings only taken from 2019. Stefan de Bott, the 24-year-old from South Africa, heads out onto the route. He was a late replacement for Daryl Impey to the South African team. Rode and finished the road race in 52nd place, second in the National Time Trial Championships in 2020. And he was the African time trial champion. He did the tour, finished the ninth stage, but had a nasty crash and was unable to fully recover from that. He's a time trialist of note. And the pride of Polruis Gymnasium in Stellenbosch. He grew up in the Boland town of Worcester. And this is a dream come true for Stefan de Bott of South Africa. The only South African in the time trial.
Well, he picked up his passion for cycling when he got a hand-me-down bike from his brother. And I know all too well about hand-me-downs, being the youngest of three. So he'd be very grateful for that. Now it's got him to the Olympic Games. And he's looking good at the start of the time trial. Very composed. I love looking at all the technical aspects of the shoe covers and the socks and the materials. You can see the different materials in different places. That's all scientifically been proven in wind tunnels.
Hugo Hull is something of a time trial specialist. 21st in Rio. This is his second Games experience. Rolls off the start line, the 30-year-old Canadian. Around the top 30 in the World Championships. Another who started as a multi-sport athlete early on in his life and found the passion for cycling.
You can see the men with their radios. Just between the shoulder blades is the most common place you'll see the radios. But they are very important for a time trialer in regards to the fact that the fastest position on the bike is, with these aerodynamic helmets, is to look straight down. And they're often looking at their computers and power output as well. So place the radios between the shoulder blades. The air comes off the helmet and straight over that part of the back. But it's so important. The position, the frontal surface area, obviously their gears on specific parts of the course, but it's made a huge difference with technology going to electric gears because it just allows them to put more pressure on the pedals while changing gears.
Representing Estonia, Tanel Kangert. Third Olympic Games for Tanel Kangert. Seventh at the World Championships in 2019. hasn't been able to replicate that before or since, but he is a multiple national champion. Finished the Olympic road race a couple of days ago, and it was a really tough road race, 46th there, and that'll be a factor. One might feel how riders have recovered from that when we get down to the business end.
It was just amazing what we witnessed in that road race with the amount of riders going back for ice from the team car drinks. It's like nothing we've ever seen before in a road race. So many athletes and lead riders as well going back. Without the radio communication in the road race, they also wanted to get back to the team car and communicate with the race directors. Picking up speed now, I just love that sound of a disc wheel on the road. These men will also be riding the tubeless tyres for maximum speed.
Well, what an occasion for this man. He's the second oldest in the field. Nicholas Roach in his fourth Olympic Games. The Irishman at the age of 37 heads out onto the course for the individual time trial. Incredible career in service of others for the main part, but a real passion for the sport, obviously. His genes are fantastic. Father Stephen, road race world champion in 1987, and Tour and Giro winner as well. So really, what a privilege for him to continue that legacy here. And well, at the age of 37, maybe his last opportunity. Stefan de Bot of South Africa, nicely positioned on his time trial machine. For the Astana Premier Tech team on the World Tour, having been with the Africa's team, Quebeca team, for a number of years. The skin suit of Michael Kugler. He's the road race champion of the Czech Republic.
You can see how quickly they get into that aero position and get themselves into the right gear. Try to keep the head down as much as possible. You can see Kirkel here opting not to wear a visor or sunglasses.
Well, this is Nikias Arndt.
Well, he looks good on a time trial bike, doesn't he? He looks very well drilled. You can really tell when different riders spend time on their time trial bike, and it's very hard for a pro rider with so many demands in the World Tour and so much travelling and racing to fit in specific time trial training. But it's the ones that do and spend a lot more time on their time trial bike that tend to come up with the goods at the championships.
Very specific art, and yeah, not every rider. Well, I dare to say that even those who do perfect it, it is a really, really tough ask for every single one of them. They dig so deep and learn to suffer.
Yeah, it really takes a special person to be able to do time trialing as a specific event.
Well, New Zealand have two riders, and this is George Bennett, who heads off. He was the silver medalist on the time trial in their national championship for the last 2 years.
And the amount of things that have to go through their mind, we could just see George Bennett playing around with his hand position, which they say makes a huge difference. Different techniques from different riders, but they've all been tested in the wind tunnel, and the position of their hands is something that you'll see them playing around with as we're back to the Irish rider Nicholas Roach.
And a 44.2 kilometer time trial. It's quite a lengthy test. Pacing is going to be critical for all these riders. You don't want to burn too many matches too early. Here's our first rider, Ahmed Badreddin Weiss, nears the 9.7 kilometer position. You can see the crowd cheering the rider behind him, so he's been closed down quite quickly. And Said Safrazadeh has already made up a minute and 17 seconds of his minute and 30 second deficit he had on the start. 90 seconds the gap between the two riders as they leave the start ramp. A bit of Belgian corner going on there.
The famous Belgian corner. Well, I think every corner at this year's World Championships is going to be a Belgian corner. One huge festivity for the World Championships at the end of this year in Belgium.
There's not much flat on this course, but this is about it. Nicky Assant keeping a really tidy rhythm in that big deep section on the front and the disc at the back. Body position critical, lack of movement is vital.
Well, you can see he's in the big chain ring, that last look that we had, but he was pretty high up on the cassette at the back, which means when we get to some of the stronger riders at the finish, we'll probably see them down around the 13 or 14 on this section, but must be slightly uphill or with a headwind.
The weather conditions will play a factor, but at the moment the breeze doesn't seem to be too strong. It was a little higher a little earlier, and the threat of rain was much stronger a little bit earlier.
10 seconds.
One of two Portuguese riders, Nelson Oliveira.
3, 2, 1, go.
Seventh in Rio in 2016 and 18th in London in 2012. So a man who knows his way around a time trial course, Nelson Oliveira. And no doubt thrives a little on it as well. But he's not the Portuguese national champion. He will go later, and that's João Almeida. Hugo Hulle in the big chain ring, pounding it out for Canada.
It's just such a fine art to not go into the red and explode in a time trial. It just takes so much practice to know exactly where that spot is, because once you overcook it and you go too far into the red, you can blow up. But these are time trial specific specialists and they know exactly where their limits are. A lot of riders will be riding to power. You can see how important it is to riders rolling off the ramp and coming into the finish to hit that computer. Make sure they've got that data just for future performances.
Nicky Assant starts the climb. I can tell you that Emmanuel Gebrekazabir of Eritrea is the fastest through the 9.7 kilometer first time split of the four riders so far. 14 minutes, 9.56 seconds is his time, but Nicky Assant is likely to sweep that away.
Well, interestingly, we've seen on this climb different styles. Riders that are out of the seat, really punching over the climb, and then riders that just settle into a rhythm. So Nicky Assant looks to be in a very good rhythm at the moment. Staying in the big chain ring, but up near the top of the cassette on the back.
Stefan de Bott nearing the base of the climb. Tucking in as low as possible, represent as small a target as you possibly can when riding a time trial machine. Aero position and tuck is so important. They have a 5 kilometer downhill as they come back towards the track. They'll do that twice. And he's onto the climb. spectators along the route, so it'll be of great encouragement to all the riders to have spectators along the route.
It's extremely hard to hear the atmosphere in these aero helmets once they cover the ears. They've got race radio in one ear, so they're getting instructions from the car right behind just to let them know how their cadence is going and to keep breathing. Most of these riders are carrying a drink bottle as well. It's an aero bottle, so specifically for the time trial bikes. And some studies have shown that it's actually faster to have bottles on your time trial bike rather than not have bottles. So even if they don't need to drink, they probably will carry a drink bottle just for aerodynamics on their bikes.
The science of time trialing, it is never ending, isn't it? Tanel Kangat now here by Estonia. Stefan de Bott has posted the fastest time now at the first split by 7 seconds from Nikias Arndt. He said that climb, though, still has a long way to go. And Tanel Kangat started just after Hugo Hull. All focus.
Now, it's a common sight that you see in time trials, the mouth wide open, trying to get as much oxygen in as possible. As we now see Hull out of the seat, attacking the climb, coming into that first time check.
He'll do this twice, of course, and as we've been saying, it's just about pacing yourself. So 13 seconds he takes out of the time of the bot. Meanwhile, up ahead, a couple of riders have passed through the 15-kilometer time check. This is Lagab, the, beg your pardon, the Portuguese rider Oliveira is next to hit that climb. National champion four times, but not since 2016. Almeida has been the dominant rider in the time trial into Portugal since then. Of time trials this year. He was 34th in the Dauphiné's time trial on stage 4, 41st at stage 3's time trial in the Paris-Nice. No gloves for Oliveira. Personal preference?
Well, I'd probably prefer to go no gloves in this climate. It's quite hot and sticky, and you really do have to have a good feeling of your gears, and if some riders are trying to change the screen to see their power and things like that, I'd probably opt for no gloves. And a lot of riders are, even though they have recently done a lot of studies on the material being faster than the skin, the gloves is one thing that you'll see with some of the top riders towards the end of this time trial probably opt for no gloves. They'll have their socks as high as they can, the shorts as low as they can. Top riders probably opting for the skin suit, with that new science showing that if you've got the right materials, they can be a lot faster than skin.
Daniel Kangat doesn't make an impression on Hugo Hull's time at that checkpoint. Jan Kersipu was the man who put Estonia on the cycling map, so to speak. So he's fourth fastest through there. So Nico Roach is going about his business here so many times, of course. Been on the tour for many, many years. In fact, the oldest rider in the field. He does have a couple of time trial wins in his career.
You can
Art van Aert doing his prep, putting the number on.
You can see the concentration that can go into placing a number on the skin suit. I know when I was racing that I was very particular about how aerodynamic and well placed the number is on that skin suit. It's amazing how much actually goes into being a specialist time trial rider. Something I certainly wasn't, but even for a road race, placing that number on, you really do want to have it in a aerodynamic and comfortable position.
Well, Nico Roach is going to go through quite some way off Hugo's time. I say an Irish national time trial champion of his 8 career wins. I beg your pardon, 12 career wins over the years. So our pace setter right at the start of the day, Ahmed Weiss, has been passed. Meanwhile, Stefan de Bort is tapping out really, really well. Looking good as the South African Weiss is suffering. And the Iranian rider, Safrazadeh. Coming back in towards the track, and they'll go out for another lap as Hugo Hull. Keeping very, very still and on the descent. It's a chance to recover.
Yeah, very high speeds. You can just see controlling the bike there. A little bit of wind, and they've got those disc wheels and deep front rims as well. There's a little bit of wind. If some of these riders are under 70 kilos, you can really feel it.
From the Czech Republic, Michael Kuklir. Hugo's time is standing up tidily. Meanwhile, the Algerian now, Lagab, is being hunted down by Emmanuel Gebrezegabir, the Eritrean. Dead still, keeping the head down, presenting an aerodynamic, as aerodynamic position as he possibly can. But it'll tell you that this isn't flat. It's a drag. Tap, 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 you hear Nelson Oliveira's wheels on that tar. Shout out to Nicky Sant. So George Bennett closing in on that time split, the first one at nine, just under 10 k's, 9.7 k's. Forty-five seconds down.
Well, Hugo Hull has definitely put out a pretty fast time at that first time check, but being a longer race here for the men in the time trial, it is all about pace setting, and you can see a lot change in the last half of the race.
And conditions can change, of course. The weather conditions have been a little unsettled in the Tokyo area over the last few days, but good dowsings of rain. And then the heat returned this morning as de Bort. Looking very good, the South African. Second fastest on the course at the moment through the second time split as well, by 16 seconds on Hugo Hull.
Orson Craddock out there on the course coming up to that first time check as well, hitting the climb out of the seat.
Well, Lawson Craddock, one of the two Americans, here, Brandon McNulty the other. And Craddock, a wonderful story from 2018 in his Tour de France, when he crashed on the first day and broke his collarbone, broke his shoulder, in fact, and then continued to ride the Tour with that shoulder.
raising funds with every stage that he finished for a great cause. It was inspirational to see that he could continue. He must have been in a world of pain, and often he was the last rider across the finish line. I think he did finish with the Lanton Rouge, the last rider of the Tour de France, but an inspiration just to get through it. Hugo Hull now. Just looks like he's really powering on.
Yeah, the Canadian is putting everything out there, and you can see there's a bit of a breeze that he's working into. And it's really exposed on the racetrack.
So they've got pretty fast surfaces and smooth roads out there, so maybe they'll be riding dry weather tires with not too much rain in sight for the afternoon.
Yeah, Ull's time is standing up well with Nelson Oliveira about to close in on it. Hydration and nutrition absolutely critical in a race like this.
We saw some of the riders roll off the start line with a gel just down the front of their skin suit. Some of them preferred to put it just on the leg of the skin suit so they can pull it out. But yeah, there are quite a few riders that have started with a gel in today's time trial. I'll probably use that in the last half of the race just for that little bit extra energy.
Out the saddle the last time we saw him. Now he's just powering through as Hugo Hull. That was the situation at 9.7 kilometers. Sweeping long corners, very wide open. He's set exposed to finding the right lines.
Looks like he's really done the recon and he knows the lines to take using every inch of the road.
And it's a very long straight, this the finishing straight on the Fuji Speedway. And they'll go through the start-finish area once and then come back out for a second lap. The first opportunity for the spectators to get a look at the riders. Zafrazadeh. Taken him 32 minutes 9.27 seconds to finish the lap. And Ahmed Weiss, a minute and 46 behind him. Remember, 90 seconds the gap between. But Hugo Hull is the man who seems to be setting the early pace here. Three tranches of riders going off. There's a pause at the moment. Wilson Craddock and Nelson Oliveira were the last two, and then there's a break before our next dozen riders will head off. Spearheaded by Theo Gegenhardt as Gebrezegibir is closing in on the line, and he should be appreciably faster than Zafrazadeh. Indeed, just under 2 minutes, 1:57.24. The gap now is Gebrezegibir. The Eritrean takes the time split there, popping out. Now, this is Nikias Arndt powering through. Arndt, and he will post a time significantly faster than all the other four riders by a minute and 11 seconds as he hunts down the Algerian Azzedine Lagab.
He certainly is moving, he's powering along. A lot of experience.
Of course, the selection for the Olympic Games is quite a tricky thing when you've got the riders who ride the road race must ride, or the riders who ride the time trial must have ridden the road race. And it does mean that some riders are going to miss out because the nation may be focusing more on the road race, and the skill set of a time trialist might not be necessarily suited to the road race. 243 kilometers. Really, really tough and hard road race.
Interestingly, we saw Rohan Dennis pull out of the road race and not ride the road race just to save himself for the time trial. And that could have come a lot down to the conditions. It was so hot that racing 234 kilometres in that heat would certainly have done a lot of damage and need some really significant recovery in order to pull out the best ride possible in the individual time trial.
Well, the 2019 African time trial champion Stefan de Bot has just gone through the halfway spot as the fastest on the course at the moment by 18.22 seconds from Nicky Assant. But again, they get faster and faster generally in a race like this. The fastest athletes go last, so Hugo Hull is the man who's likely to post the fastest time. He really is charging. Well, way to go still. Can he get the better of his teammate, his trade teammate, Stefan de Bot? I think he will. He does by 17.17 seconds.
And getting that feedback via radio from the team car can also really lift the morale of a rider fastest at the time check after a lap. But just to imagine how much pain they're in, and they're only halfway, they have to endure that kind of pain for another 20 odd kilometres. Such a special art to be able to ride through that pain barrier and continue the same at power output.
Yeah, they're averaging these faster riders 46 kilometers an hour for that first lap.
Very fast times, given that it's quite undulating. There are not many flat places. Even that straight up the finish line is a false flat, very tough straight on the Formula One circuit.
This is, that was where the New Zealander was happy on the climbs. This is the Estonian Kangert. The technology behind time trial equipment is quite something. It's an art form all of its own.
The amount of time that these riders spend in the wind tunnel, just trying to reduce that frontal surface area and make sure that everything from the tyres and the shoe covers, the materials of their skin suits, the position of their hands, the position of their head, different helmets. And it's a big issue when a rider changes trade team and they have to then start all the wind tunnel testing again on a completely new set of equipment, from the bikes to the helmets and the materials of the skin suit and so on. So it's a very revolving, important aspect of time trialing, the amount of effort that needs to go into the bike setup, positioning on different brands of bikes and using different helmets and different suits. So for the riders who are specialising in the time trial, they have to spend so much time in the wind tunnel and on their time trial bikes to make sure they're comfortable and that they can get the maximum power output for a sustained period of time.
Now, Lawson Craddock is out the saddle. He was the second last of the riders to start in this early tranche. Grabs a bottle.
Yeah, so he's carrying no bottle cages on his bike, so that would have been well planned out, that he'd take a specific drink, whether it be sports drink or water. And one thing that's quite noticeable too with the position of time trial riders, they tend to ride with their cleats positioned further back on the shoe. compared to your road riders and sprinters specifically. Time trialers like to have their cleat positioned quite far back on the shoe. So as we say, it's never ending, the technology and science that goes behind time trial riding. First of all, you have to be a very, very special type of bike rider to be able to do a time trial. It's such a hard discipline, mentally and physically, to be able to work through that hurt, that pain threshold. As we look at Nicholas Roach here, number 37, representing Ireland, comes from a very famous family of athletes. Stephen Roach being the most notable, and we can now see that they're moving into the very, very big gears, so super high power output, super fast part of the course.
Yeah, it's how far can you push yourself without going into the red zone for too long. There are various areas on this course, particularly coming back to the track, the racetrack, where recovery will be maximized on the descent.
Well, you can see with Roach how much time he's trying to keep his head down just for those aerodynamics, meaning a little bit less output, power output for the same speed. Some riders can put a lot of faith into their team car and the race radio and not need to put their head up. But 1 minute 46 down on Hulet.
It's the sixth fastest time through the halfway spot of the race, 22.1 kilometres. Cousin, of course, is Dan Martin. He won't be riding in the time trial. So Lawson Craddock making his way in now. Second tranche of riders will be about 14 minutes before they head out. We'll start theirs, and then the last lot of riders in just over an hour's time. That will contain most of the medal contenders, the likes of Tom Dumoulin, Kaspar Askreen, many people's outsider, Primoz Roglic, Remy Cavagna, Rohan Dennis, Mark Panard, Stefan Kung, all these names. We'll be throwing the hats into the ring for potential Olympic glory today. 1:32.51 down. Fifth fastest behind Hugo Uhl's time at the intermediate split, the halfway mark.
George Bennett, coming from a mountain bike background as well. Back in November 2019, he underwent surgery to remove three ribs due to chronic slipping rib syndrome. That sounds quite serious, but it's amazing to hear the surgeries that these athletes have been through and their comebacks to the sport at the highest level. And you can see George Bennett, the position of his hands there, just making sure. And sometimes it'll be the race radio that just reminds them the most aerodynamic position. He's trying to get everything he can out of the bike.
Little glance up towards the finish line. It doesn't seem to get any closer. And it's not the ultimate finish line, of course. This is just the halfway spot on this 44.2 kilometer circuit. The quality of the field at this year's individual time trial is quite outstanding. Just two riders have finished in the top 10 of the World Championships in Imola last year and not here. And it shows the depth of time trialing in places like Belgium, when Victor Campagnats, who was the second best Belgian at the World Championships, can't get into their squad. Alex Dowsett of Great Britain didn't make the cut. They threw all their eggs into the road race at basket because they were looking at Adam and Simon Yates and maybe Geraint Thomas there. Didn't ultimately work for them. Thomas and Theo Gegenhardt had a fall, and wonder how Thomas will feel today, having had a couple of days to recover.
Yeah, he didn't look good, did he, when he pulled off the track in the road race, so it will be interesting to see how he's recovered for the time trial. No doubt coming to this Olympic Games, talking about Geraint Thomas, that he would have had his focus on the time trial. So it'll be interesting to see how he's recovered from that fall in the road race.
Now the world champion from Imola and the most prolific time trial winner at the moment, Filippo Ganna, will be last to leave today. He's a very big, powerful unit, is the Italian. And there is a school of thought that this course might be just a little too hilly for him. Wout van Aert has shown incredible form, winning three very different stages at the Tour de France and being much the animator in the chase pack behind Richard Carapaz in the road race here in Tokyo a couple of days ago.
It'll be very interesting to see how Wout van Aert's pulled up. He's had such a heavy program the last couple of months, but the course does suit him, and he looked quite relaxed the last vision we got of him before the start of this time trial, just still staying very relaxed and cool in his team tent.
Stefan Kung, the Swiss riders, had two really good time trials of late, second in the stage two time trial on the Tour de France and fourth in this final time trial on the day before the Champs-Élysées, so he's shown some good form. Did win the short 10.9 kilometer time trial, the prologue for the Tour de Suisse. That's very different to a time trial of this nature. So, the 12 riders having started, this is how they stand right now. Hugo Hull of Canada, 17.17 seconds ahead of Stefan de Bort of South Africa after the halfway mark, with Nicky Assant in third place. It's an ever-evolving picture we'll be bringing to you throughout the afternoon as to how this race unfolds. The fastest riders scheduled to leave last. Proliferation of golf clubs in this area, all they wind their way in and around them on this course. And Oliveira suffering but digging very deep. He is about to leave the track and head out onto the loop in the hills, so to speak, which takes him past, right past, two of those luscious large golf courses. All in the shadow of Mount Fuji. I think the low cloud is obscuring the great mountain from view today. Gould keeping sensible in the shade there, trying to just give himself every opportunity not to be exposed to this brutal heat. So the actual temperature out there is around 28 degrees when you're pounding away on a tar road. It'll be much hotter. Theo Gegenhardt, the Giro d'Italia champion from last year. All the preparations being done, numbers affixed, and riders preparing to get out and tackle this very, very tough course. Patrick Conrad, a stage winner at the Tour de France.
Rohan Dennis just playing around with his race radio. Richie Port from Australia looking very calm.
He's got around 7 minutes before he leaves. Theo Gegenhardt will leave in around 6 minutes' time, and then Richie Port will head out after him. He was one of the best time trialists around a good 7-8 years ago. Hasn't had a time trial win for a long time. His last was back in 2017. Last of 8 wins in time trials at the Dauphiné. Steady rhythm being tapped out by Hugo Hulle of Canada. And that's the sound of that big disc wheel on the back as he turns into the climb one more time. Oliveira. He is just behind Lawson Craddock. On their second lap of this course. Second ascent of the climb for Hugo Hull. Stefan de Bort has gone through the fourth time check, which is this, just ahead, and he was 17 seconds slower than Hull. So Hull is making up a little time because he's made up a second on de Bort since the halfway point. Is suffering. Now, this is Remco Evenepoel. Many people feel this is a man who could be in contention today. He does start as the 24th rider, so you could enjoy these conditions. If they had to change later on in the day as the afternoon progresses, then it'll give those late starters perhaps, who knows, depending on what those conditions are, but it could be tougher.
Yeah, it's a big question mark. Evenepoel, there's been some people saying put your money on him for a medal here at the Tokyo Olympics, but since he had an accident last year, we haven't seen too much of him, but he has been concentrating on this individual time trial here at the Olympic Games, so we'll see what Evenepoel can do. Wout van Aert, of course, from Belgium, also one of the big favourites. And Tom Dumoulin, we haven't mentioned him yet, from the Netherlands, no doubt to be one of the big contenders for a medal here. It's quite an open race, and there's Wout van Aert just relaxing. He's in the last wave, second last rider off the start ramp.
Tom Dumoulin. But this is going to be a race to savour. That's Evenepoel. He's such a young man, a rich talent. He burst onto the scene when he won the European Time Trial Championships a couple of years ago. And at the age of 21, he's the second youngest in the field. But he's already got 16 wins to his name as a pro rider, with 4 of those on the time trial bike.
A phenomenal talent, Evenepoel. He actually skipped the under-23 ranks just to go directly into the elites, into a pro team. And he certainly is one of the big stars of the future. So there's a lot of talk about Evenepoel and what he can do here, but certainly a rider to watch in the future.
Nelson Oliveira, I think it's Lawson Craddock up ahead, who's starting to feel the heat from the Portuguese rider. There's Nikias Arndt, averaging 45 kilometres an hour at the moment. That's some riding from the German. No hesitation, moving out of the slip, and away he goes. Well, the rider being passed, it's never a good feeling, I'm sure, but just gives him something to try and latch onto, even if he's losing ground all the time.
Theo Gegenhardt just in the starting ramp now, the first rider off in the second wave, so he won't have riders to catch and pass for that extra little bit of motivation, but a very experienced time trial rider. He'll be riding to his own pace and power.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Great Britain's Theo Gegenhardt heads out onto the course for the men's individual time trial. 44.2 kilometers ahead for the British rider who won the Giro d'Italia last year. It's just off the Tour de France and had a crash in the road race when, by all accounts, it was his wheel that hit an expansion joint on the road, and he went down, and his teammate Geraint Thomas followed him onto the dirt. He's done a couple of time trials this year. He was ninth in the Stage 5 time trial at the Tour de France, and sixth in the Stage 4 time trial at the, beg your pardon, he was fourth, 34th in the time trial at the Critérium du Dauphiné, Theo Gegenhardt, and 41st in Paris-Nice. He really did put his name in lights when he won the Giro last year. Kai Hindley and he were the two young men making everyone stand up and take notice. Here's an Australian who's been around for quite a lot longer.
3, 2, 1, go!
Richie Port. Away he goes on another time trial, but for a man of his experience, this is his first Olympic time trial. He missed out last year, crashed in the road race in Rio and couldn't ride the time trial, so here's an opportunity to redemption.
He's had quite a faster start than most of the other riders that we've seen, aggressive out of the ramp, high speed through these corners. He will be very confident with his recon he's done on the course, and he looks motivated, cautious through that corner. But I think Richie Port's actually quite hungry for this time trial.
Hugo Hull, the Canadian, who's at the moment the fastest on the course. There's around 7 kilometres to go, Hugo Hull.
He'll certainly be motivating getting that communication from the team car that he's had the fastest splits in that first wave of riders.
The sensation of their last year or two, Remco Evenepoel, is on the course in the men's individual time trial. The Belgian was the silver medalist at the 2019 World Championships. He was the junior world champion in 2018. And he's gone straight into elite level riding here as a sensation.
Yeah, he won the junior world titles in both the road race and the individual time trial. His father was a professional cyclist, Patrick Evenepoel. He looks very comfortable on the bike. He comes from a football background. Came into cycling when he was in 2017, not too long ago, and he has really taken the world by storm. He's impressed so many people, straight into one of the biggest pro teams of the world. A lot of faith put in this young rider, only 21, so he'll be using this. Oh, you can see that form there, how low he's got his head there for aerodynamics.
Yeah, he's had an interesting year because he had that terrible crash in the Giro and had 8 months, that was late last year, out breaking his pelvis at Il Lombardia.
2, 1, go!
he did go to the Giro, but hasn't done much racing this year, but did come back to win the Tour of Belgium. Alberto Bettiol on the course, the Tour of Flanders winner from 2019. He attacked and went away on the Eau de Quavemont and just almost time trial to the finish.
Well, the Italians, they won a bronze medal in the women's road race. Missed out on the podium in the men's race, and now they have one of the favourites, the last rider off, Filippo Ganna.
He's done three time trials this year. Meanwhile, we're with Theo Gegenhardt.
The British are known for actually being a country that puts most of their effort into the aerodynamics and testing for time trialling. So we'll see Geraint Thomas out a little bit later. And he is back to Richie Port, the Australian hopes, with Richie and Rohan Dennis. Richie Port won the Dauphiné just before the Tour de France, was in great form, and a very hard Tour de France for Richie Port. So be interesting to see how he's recovered, how his form is now.
Late replacement, late call up to the Olympic team. This is the youngest rider in the field, Lukas Kubis from Slovakia. And he replaced Peter Sagan, who was injured and needed surgery after the 2021 Tour de France this year. So a big opportunity for the young man to make a name for himself. He didn't finish the road race. He hadn't been called up at such late notice. Understandable if things didn't quite go according to plan. Evenepoel tucked as low as possible.
Looks to me that he spent a lot of time on his time trial bike. He's got that coated chain for that, you know, trying to get the least amount of friction as possible. Another aspect of just trying to get everything out of your bike. So these riders do, obviously, they train their bodies to the maximum. A little bit of a slip.
Well, this is, he's a young man, so the first opportunity to come to an Olympic Games. Let's have a look here. Whoopsie. You don't want to, I mean, the excitement of it, the adrenaline's pumping. Toms Hiskoins from Latvia. He is the Latvian national champion. Quickly into position.
You see those Trek bicycles just specially painted in that colour for those riders that went to the Olympic Games. Always nice to get a nice fresh bike before the Olympic Games just to make the emphasis on how special it is. It's just an achievement to make it to an Olympic Games.
Nearly 40 riders who came to the Olympic Games or took part in the road race and the time trial were completing the Tour de France just a week earlier. It's a really, really brutal sport, this. They ride week in, week out all over the world. Many of those who finished the road race a couple of days ago already back home, Europe and the Americas, wherever they might be, and preparing for their next appointment. Nicky Assant is getting towards the finish as our first rider to complete the individual time trial here in Tokyo and post a time of 58 minutes, 49.39 seconds. First rider in, Nicky Assant of Germany, a very tidy time indeed. How long will that stand up as the fastest time?
Well, as we mentioned earlier, they seem to seed the riders, faster ones right at the finish, so we get the excitement of seeing faster and faster times come in as the competition goes on. And Debod looks like he's going to put in a fast time as well. He's going to take the hot seat.
Yeah, Arndt's time is not going to last too long, because here is Stefan Debod, crosses the line. And by 52 5.29 seconds. He is the new leader. So a good performance by De Bot, who had to replace Daryl Impey in the team. Very experienced Daryl Impey. Ryan Gibbons and Nicholas Flamini were the other two riders who were in the road race. And De Bot has done an excellent job here in his first Olympic experience. 52nd in the road race and posting a handy time of 57 minutes, 57.10 seconds. There's the Iranian rider. He's coming home. Said Safarzadeh. Hugo Hull in the background, the Canadian. He is likely to usurp the bot in the hot seat. And Safarzadeh will complete his time trial. But Hugo Hull has been very impressive of the early tranche of riders. It might be close. Only just.
Wow.
That's close. Such an honor at the Olympic Games to sit in that hot seat. And De Bot, he did a fantastic ride and deserved every moment that he was to sit in that hot seat, but very quickly taken by Hugo Hull. Very, very close.
He glances up and we'll see 0.64. seconds, so he's into the hot seat. So Stefan De Bot, his moment in the hot seat is short-lived. Number two, he will have to move into that. Well done, young man. And Emmanuel Gebrezabgir from Eritrea. Seasoned World Tour professional with four Grand Tours under his belt, but he's not a time trial specialist. But he's done the job here for his country, Eritrea. Developing a lovely pipeline of riders into the World Tour, predominantly through Africa's team, Kubeka, but more and more reaching out to ride on other teams, Mahawi Kudus and the like, as Lagab of Algeria finishes 7:25.07 down. And this is Ahmed Bedreddin Uwais. First rider to start. And the man is a refugee, one of 29 refugee athletes at the Olympic Games. Has completed his time trial.
Alberto Bettiol for Italy. Just settling into his rhythm. Quite experienced all round. Beautiful sound of that rear disc wheel. He's pushing a pretty hard gear, so he's moving along.
John Izaguirre, the 32-year-old Spaniard, who heads off now. Another who started the time trial, rode the Tour de France, as Tanel Kangert completes his ride. 1 minute, 8 seconds, and 8.40 seconds down. Theo Gegenhardt through the first checkpoint, 30 seconds down. He's a very fine climber. He may make some of that time up on this climb, as Remco Evenepoel is still tucked in that very, very good aero position. It looks as though he's made to ride a time trial bike.
He certainly does. His position there is near perfection for a time trialist. can see he's got brand new tyres on for today. They'll have an absolutely identical bike on the roof of the car behind them in case they have a mechanical issue. There's so much pressure on the mechanics at this level. They go over the bikes, not once, not twice, not three times, but all throughout the evening before a big event like this.
Maciej Bodnar, the Polish national time trial champion. Sixth in Rio in 2016. And this is his third games because he finished 25th in London in 2012. Former European silver medalist in 2017, Richie Port.
Well, a little bit off the pace at this point, which is not a good sign. You really do need to go out blistering. Unless you're one of those riders that can really, really bring it home. But to already be more than 40 seconds down, it's not a good sign for Richie Port. He just hasn't seemed to have, we saw in the road races, well, he hasn't seemed to got that form that he had before the Tour de France, but the Tour de France can take a lot out of a bike rider.
Remco Evenepoel will be the next man to cross that checkpoint. It'll be fascinating to see the time this young Belgian sensation lays down.
Well, Hugo Hula will be in a pretty positive position, sitting in the hot seat at the moment, because Evenepoel is going to be a little bit off the pace. Let's see, he might not be.
Well, Hugo Hula's time is standing up well. Very well, 6 seconds, just over 6 seconds for Evenepoel.
Yeah, Evenepoel probably does have the experience to bring it back, but as we saw in the women's race, it's not a course where you can really conserve too much at the start. If you want to be in gold medal contention at the Olympic Games, you really need to attack it from the start. And Evenepoel doing a fantastic job. He's really picking up the speed now, and that's one thing with the race radios. When you get that time check and you're not number one over the line, it can really affect your rhythm, because you can see he's putting a lot of effort in now, and you've just got to make sure you don't go too far into the red.
Nicholas Roach approaching the finish line of the time trial for Ireland. The oldest man in the field completes his time trial in Tokyo at the Olympic Games. 3 minutes, 26.67 seconds down. The pain is over for Nico Roach. Might look like a grin, I don't think it is. Alberto Bettiol gets some encouragement roadside, and he's going well. He's going very well, 5.20 seconds up. So the fastest time through the first time split, Alberto Bettiol. Leaving the start at is Max Schachmann.
The last rider out of the ramp in the second wave of riders. So just one wave of riders to start the time trial.
Michael Cuclier. 1 hour, 41.55 seconds. Thomas Skoins. Oh, he's got Lukas Kubis, the young Slovakian, ahead of him. And he's approaching the turn up to the first climb. Now they opt not to wear the long sleeves or the gloves.
No shoe covers. Pushing a pretty big gear there.
Well, George Bennett, he's a climber generally, and so he'll be satisfied that he's completed this time trial. just over 2.5 minutes adrift of the current hot seat sitter, Hugo Hull, coming in 28.39 seconds over an hour.
Oh, you can just see the pain on the face, the tension on the chain. Not too many opportunities on this course to take the pressure off the pedals. As we see Evenepoel, after his last time check, he really seemed to dig in and lift the pace.
Yeah, I think he may have been hoping it'd be a little bit quicker, but it's time and it's pacing which is the key here on this demanding, undulating course. 846 meters of climbing over the 44 kilometers. So there's an enormous amount of hard work to be done. This is the Danish star Kasper Askeren.
Yeah, one of the favorites for today as well. We can put him up there in the favorites list. Kasper Askeren just warming up and very focused and visualizing.
Nelson Oliveira, the first of the two Portuguese riders in the field. He's had a good second half of the ride, improved his time splits to the leaders. Sixth fastest, fourth fastest, fifth fastest, and now he is fourth fastest across the line. A minute, just over 1 minute, 2.76 seconds down.
And a shake of the head as he crosses the line indicates he's not happy with his ride. But we can now confirm of the first wave of riders, it's Hugo Hula that has the fastest time of those first riders off in the first wave.
Squins up the saddle one more time on this brutally tough climb. And the one thing, you'll get plenty of emotion and very graphic feel of what it's like out there on the bike, but you will not feel the heat.
The burning in the legs, I can feel it just sitting here watching those riders. They have an amazing ability to just keep pushing through the pain and disconnect that mental feeling of pain and just keep riding to power. And the instructions from the team car behind as we're back with Evenepoel, one of Belgium's big hopes for the future. He certainly achieved a lot in his very early and short career so far. But Evenepoel, he looks absolutely splendid on the bike. Fantastic aerodynamic position.
Well, he's going well, but he's still a little bit down on the Canadian's time. He's put in a super ride. And the more riders that come through, the better at standing up at the moment.
Yeah, it'll be no use for Evenepoel to be riding off the benchmark of Hugo Hule because there will be faster riders to come.
Patrick Conrad, sensational win at the Tour de France.
Theo Gegenhardt of Great Britain, a lot of experience.
Theo Gegenhardt. We'll have Geraint Thomas riding a little bit later for Great Britain.
Well, Van Aert, one of today's big favourites. He's wearing the ice vest, keeping the core temperature cool. He's got the fan going as well. Just ticking the legs over. The winner of the women's individual time trial. That's got to be motivation. Well, Tom Dumoulin. Sorry, I think I mentioned Walt Van Aert. Tom Dumoulin in the Netherlands camp there. Just very staying very cool. And got that motivation of Annemiek van Vleuten winning the women's individual time trial here today. So we haven't... it's a big question mark over Tom Dumoulin. But an exciting rider to watch coming up in the last wave of riders.
American Lawson Craddock completes his time trial. And he will be down at the moment in 10th place, 5 minutes, 56.53 seconds down on Eagle's time. So the clouds banking high on the mountains, but staying away. Looks as though he might still have some fuel tucked up his legs there. And the gel in there. So Alexei Lutsenko. Beg your pardon, yes it is. Lutsenko's out on the course. We missed his start. Also Rigo Urán, here he is. Rigoberto Urán, second of the road race in Rio. Time trial silver medalist at the World Championships in 2015. And his role and his riding style has changed quite a bit since then, 6 years ago. So Evenepoel. So much attention on this young man. So everyone wants a piece of him because he's made such a sensational start. But well, there are lots of youngsters and slightly older riders, the likes of Mathieu van der Poel and Wout van Aert, who are drawing attention to the sport now. Senko.
Of course, Betty Olstuhl holds the fastest time through that first check. Will he be able to sustain his effort with the fast time posted early by Hugo Hulé?
He won the time trial at the Criterium de Dauphiné earlier this year at Lindsay Tsenko. He was 10th in the Stage 5 Tour de France time trial. Yeah, Betiol surprised all and sundry by winning the Flanders in 2019. There's how it looks at the moment. Uhl, Stefan de Bott, and Nikias Arndt, the three men in the podium positions as of now. I know it won't last that long, but enjoy it while you can, as Schachmann, early stage of his ride for the German powerhouse, Max Schachmann.
Betiol really fighting now, really putting the pressure down. You can see he's just trying to take every second out on the road that he can. Really digging deep.
Yonis Aguirre. He goes through seventh fastest at that first checkpoint. Evenepoel on the racetrack, sweeping wide open track at the corners, tucking in nicely. It looks such an uncomfortable position to be in for as long as they're in it, but if anyone's going to make it look comfortable, it's this man. He's very, very smooth.
Well, sometimes it can be those riders that don't look like they're putting all the effort in when they're so solid and smooth on the bike and all the power's just going through the pedals. It doesn't look like they're going as fast, but it's those strong riders that make it look so smooth that can bring fast times. But still off the pace of Hugo Hulé out there on the road. So
he's basically riding the same pace that I did.
Yeah.
Hulé just getting some updates about the pace out there on the road, but he'd have to be excited about the fact that he's not seeing a faster pace from Evenepoel that he did out there.
Yeah, you heard him there just saying he's basically riding the same pace as I did, so they may be very, very close if he continues like that. Bodnar, the pole going through, 36.66 seconds down on Betiol's time. So, who have we got in this last wave of riders? Tobias Foss, the Norwegian national champion. New Zealand's Patrick Bevan, many feel, could be a dark horse here. Brandon McNulty, the young American, has had a sensational time. Former junior champion of the world. Tom Dumoulin, of course, we know his pedigree. Grand Tour winner, and of course a world champion of the time trial, João Almeida, the Portuguese national champion, Kasper Asgreen from Denmark. Primoz Roglic, well, I wonder how he might go. He has excellent time trial credentials. Will they come through on this course? Geraint Thomas, Rohan Dennis, Remy Cavagna, Stefan Kung, Wout van Aert, and last to ride will be the world champion, Philippe Bogana.
Well, certainly a stellar lineup in that last wave of riders. It's difficult to say which of those riders will take the medals and how Hugo Hulda's time is going to stack up against the last wave of riders.
It's holding up quite nicely in the company of the second wave of riders. Gegenhardt goes through. The first of those, just at the moment, here is Remco Evenepoel. Closing in on Richie Port, his 92nd man.
Yeah, well, that's going to do great things for the confidence of Evenepoel. Not so good for Richie Port. And as we said, he's had a very demanding schedule since his last race win, and it might have just all caught up with him.
Well, Remco Evenepoel really is powering in towards the halfway mark of the men's individual time trial, just behind the man who started 90 seconds ahead of him 22 kilometers ago, Richie Port. But Evenepoel might be hard pressed. In fact, he's not going to post the fastest time at halfway yet, because it's Hugo Hull who still stands strong. So Evenepoel, another lap of this course to see if he can pull back that time.
Well, he looks quite relaxed, but after getting that time check, he'll know that he really needs to pick up the pace if he wants to be amongst the final wave of riders. We've got a problem here for the Spaniard.
Zagire.
He's got a cramp. Not good, and very common in the heat, but he's just trying to stretch it out. He's unclicked now. He's unclicked his foot from the pedals. Back in the pedals now. Just trying to shake it out, but it's not looking good for Izaguirre. Pedaling backwards and forwards, just trying to get rid of that cramp, but looks like it might be all over for the Spaniard today.
Shake of the head, whether that was in reaction to something said from the car behind him or just in frustration at what is happening. Max Schachmann, second of the German contenders. Goes through fifth fastest time. Bet you're losing time a little now. Went out really, really strong, the Italian. It's fourth at the moment.
Well, the Canadian, Hugo Hulet, he must be enjoying his time in the hot seat. He probably didn't expect to sit there all the way through the second wave of riders so far. Izaguirre, it looks like he's got pressure back on the pedals now after shaking out that cramp, but the head is up and down. And to win an Olympic gold medal at this level, you need to have nothing go wrong. You need the perfect ride.
Is it a mechanical issue?
No, I think it's the leg, because he did unclip from his pedal and give it a good shake. Unless he's got both a mechanical and a physical problem. But yeah, he definitely had some trouble with that left leg.
sounds as though he's a shifting problem.
I think he's just shifting into the easiest gear to take some pressure off his leg, hoping that it comes good again. But you can't afford to have that much time in trouble at this level.
Vlasov of the Russian Olympic Committee flies through. Beautiful. And heads down. He's also nudging close to Hugo Uhl's time. Early days yet, though. He was second fastest through the checkpoint as Lutsenko, who's losing time on the second sector. Alexey Lutsenko, the Kazakhstan rider. He's a contender on the time trial when perhaps it's not quite as hilly as this.
It looks like he just can't get that maximum kind of effort out of his body today, and that sometimes happens. You can come in well prepared, but if you get that tapering wrong, you can just feel dead on the day. But at Benapole, he's still chasing the fastest time of Hugo Hule. Can he bring it back? Oh, yes, it's too much for the cramp for the Spaniard. Izaguirre, he's called it a day.
Really, really disappointing as he's passed quite comfortably by Bodnar.
Is he going to try and ride that cramp out and just ride to the finish, or will he have to pull over and put the bike on the top of the car? He's really struggling.
Well, you can see the track up ahead. We focus now on Remco Evenepoel, who's starting to take back a little time on Hugo Uhl.
That'll give him confidence, getting some information from the race radio. He's probably saved a little bit to really bring this home. As we said, he looks superb in his positioning on his time trial bike. Not many riders can ride that position and get out maximum power and ride for that long with their head down, confidence in their race radio instructions when corners are coming up and things like that. But he's really got the position nailed. He's got the form. Will it be good enough for the medals? That'll give us an indication of how fast Hugo Hula's time actually was when we see the last wave of riders come out onto the track.
That is Tom Skoyns goes through a minute 45.14 down. His 13th fastest at the halfway point of the men's time trial. So 27.9k's gone, and Evenepoel is starting to eat into that time of Hugo Uhl. Kubus, the young Slovakian, the youngest rider in the field. Well, this will be a great learning experience for this youngster. Came in to replace Peter Sagan in their Slovakian team. Finished the road race. This is Rigoberto Urán. Well, Urán in his fourth Olympic Games, the 34-year-old. Going to come as close as any to Goal's time, just 4.68 seconds down in third fastest over that first half of the ride.
You'll see the more experienced riders really bring it home in the second part, having that experience of pacing themselves.
Patrick Conrad, the Austrian, minute 54 down. Austria have had their glory at these games. The most unexpected quarter in the women's road race. Anna Kissenhofer pulling off a stunning victory in the road race. Whether one calls it a surprise or an upset, I'm not sure, but
well-deserved, I would say.
Well-deserved, it certainly was. She put herself out there, got on the break early, and disappeared up the road. Regardless of what happened behind her,
Kissenhofer will be one to watch out in the future in the time trials as well, because what she did in that road race was absolutely phenomenal. So Kissenhofer's one to keep an eye out for the future, our new Olympic gold medalist in the women's road race.
From Rigoberta Aran to Remco Evenepoel, losing a few seconds from last time we saw him. There are lots of these gentle drags. I say gentle drags. There's nothing gentle about the way they ride them on the time trial bikes. They power up them, but it saps energy away. Eating away at the power and the seconds.
Well, a close fight out on the road. Evenepoel is chasing the finishing time of Hugo Hula, who's sitting in the box seat at the moment.
Alexey Lutsenko, the man from Kazakhstan, closing in on the halfway stage. So he won the Dauphiné time trial earlier this year and was 10th in the stage 5 time trial at the Tour de France. So he has good credentials in the time trial. Never really been a serial contender in the World Championships, which is where you really must be judged in the time trials. 13th in 2018, pretty decent performance.
Well, as each rider comes in, it just shows us how phenomenal that ride from Hugo Hule was to set such a blistering early time in the men's time trial. Great result from Canada, no matter what happens with this last and final wave that we've not seen start yet. All the top contenders yet to go down that ramp and start their time trial.
He was the 7th rider out there, Hugo Hule. And there's some pretty decent time trialists who followed him out onto the course, but he managed to hold it up. Well, will that time stand up in the face of this man, Remco Evenepoel?
Well, it's looking better and better for Hugo Hule. He'll be watching very closely at the time of Evenepoel.
Yeah, this would be a good benchmark because in this second wave of riders, Evenepoel might be regarded as the strongest, and certainly looking the strongest. Alberto Bettiol's going well as well. And Rigoberto Urán. Know that Yonizigira is having all sorts of trouble.
Back with Bettiol now, just a little bit further off the pace than Evenepoel in regards to Hule. But being one of the more experienced riders, we'll have to see what happens in the last part of this time trial.
So Evenepoel has put in a decent split. He's 4.19 seconds down on the fastest time through the full split set by Hugo Hule. As Matthias Bodnar posts 7th fastest through the halfway split. Rigoberto Urán, 3rd fastest through the halfway. He is not far behind Remco Evenepoel as Bodnar sets off on his second lap. Vlasov, the Russian Olympic Committee. Now he could post a good time, Alexander Vlasov. He lost a little time on from 15 to 22 kilometers. Fourth fastest through halfway, Vlasov. 6 seconds off that of Rigoberto Urán. But quite comfortably 11 seconds clear of Alberto Bettiol at the halfway stage. Gagan Hart, he is the target for Remco Evenepoel.
Yeah, he's already passed Richie Porte out on the road, and he's now closing in on Theo Gegenhardt. And that is an advantage when you've got a rider just inside in front. Evenepoel closing in on Theo Gegenhardt.
Well, Theo Gegenhardt looks as though he's having a torrid time on this time trial.
Absolutely. You can see the respect when he heard that Evenepoel was closing in all the way over to the right side of the road and give him space. Now we'll just try and fight and keep Evenepoel within distance, but not a good day for Theo Gegenhardt.
Shackman. Tidy, tidy ride by the German. Fifth fastest through the first and second time splits. And he's lost a little bit of time on the third sector.
The common sight, we'll see the mouth wide open, just trying to get as much oxygen in as possible, and the signs of the amount of pain these riders can push through. It's absolutely amazing. Not very happy with the time split though, a little shake of the head.
So this is how it looks at the halfway time split. Hugo Hull's early time standing up well. Remco Evenepoel, Rigoberto Urán, then Vlasov. Stefan de Bart of South Africa, his time holding up nicely as well. Shackman, Bettiol, Arndt and Bodnar. Shackman's still out there. Bettiol's still out there. Bodnar's still out there. There's a number of these riders, including Richie Porte. Lutsenko is still out there. Patrick Conrad is having a tough time. Conrad.
Well, can Evenepoel bring it back to take that hot seat? He's losing time. No, he's gaining time.
Gaining time now, yeah.
He's gaining time on Hule, so he is really bringing it home. We could see with his seriousness of his position and not loads of experience coming into the sport a bit later, but a phenomenal talent. Everybody's been talking about him. The Belgians are sure they're going to be on the podium today. They could have two on the podium, but Evenepoel is really, really bringing this home.
So he's got 10 seconds on Bettiol. 11 and a half on Hugo Hull. So, yeah, it's the second half and perhaps the last quarter of this course that's really playing into his hands. He's got the feel of it now, you feel. He really is in control of what he's about there.
You do see a difference, don't you? It's like that, you know, he said, okay, I'm going to let it all out now. I'm going to give it everything I've got. So body language of Hule knows that his time is now running out on that hot seat, but what a special moment to be able to sit there at the Olympic Games.
Rigoberto Urán of Colombia. Oh, he's going well as well.
Absolutely flying. He doesn't look as smooth as Evenepoel, but he's putting out the power and he's really in contention now in this second wave of riders.
He went out moderately, but he's also putting in a second lap of serious note here. Rigo Urán put himself in contention for a medal for Colombia. Into the tuck, saving a little energy here by not pedaling. There's not many opportunities to recover, but he's making maximum use of this, says Remco Evenepoel.
Well, he's the type of rider that just could put a lot of power out for a few seconds to build up that speed and then give himself just that little bit of rest before he brings this home.
He's got about 10 more minutes of suffering to get through, Remco Evenepoel of Belgium, before he crosses the line and posts the time that may well be one that the last wave of riders are going to find very difficult to shoot at and hit.
Well, there we saw that power that he just put out. A lot of power in the pedals and then a little bit of a rest. And that's the type of rider that he is. He's explosive, he's punchy, a lot of high power. And then he just takes himself a little bit of a rest. But he's moving. Speed is high for Remco Evenepoel. It's an opportunity to take a drink before this left-hand corner.
What a technical little section, that S-bend that he has to get through. It's Theo Gegenhardt. His pain continues. 3:23 down. He's into the track now, is Remco Evenepoel onto the Fuji International Speedway. And he's got time in hand over Hugo Hull, who sits in the hot seat, the Canadian. 57 minutes, 56.46 seconds is Hugo Hull's time.
He's paced himself well and he still looks strong. And doesn't he look relaxed as well? Just dripping with sweat in these conditions. Staying in the big chain ring.
The drag up to the race course itself. As Richie Port is 2:48 down. Well, Australia's real hopes sit with Rohan Dennis, and he is a double world champion. He's losing time hand over fist here, is Evenepoel.
Yeah, we saw him just take the pressure off of the pedals a few times before this climb, and he's rapidly losing time to Hugo Hulé on that climb, which is quite surprising. Has he overdone it in the middle part of the race? Well, Bettiol's also lost time in the second part of the race.
It's a very punishing 44 kilometres, this. The young man from Belgium, he looked to have gone out fairly moderately. Came through within a second or two of Hugo Hulot halfway and put the hammer down in the second half. Out to 20-second advantage, and now it's starting to shrink.
Well, you can hear in the sound, just the sound, if they're going up a gear or down a gear. And down a gear, making it just a little bit harder, higher resistance, higher speed. As he takes this left-hand turn, he can't afford to lose any time. Evenepoel coming in towards the finish, trying to better the time of Hugo Hulé. As we see Rigoberto Urán back with Evenepoel.
Well, Urán is a man who's moving up the standings. I can tell you that Vlasov is losing time. Lutsenko is losing time. But Evenepoel is now starting to claw it back off that little dip on that climb. Perhaps it was the drag up the climb there, but he's still got some time in hand over Hugo Hulé.
Well, at this point, it's all about how much you can push through that pain. how much power he's got left in those legs. You can see from his facial expressions that it's all or nothing now. It's everything that's left. Just empty the tank. I'm back with Bertiol, who seems to be laboring a little bit. Not as powerful as we saw earlier. But not too far away from the time of Hugo Houllet.
Bertiol lost a little bit of time on his third sector. Went from sixth fastest to seventh fastest. Tage Egenhardt. So having a very, very tough time trial. He should be the first to finish of this wave of riders. Beg your pardon, he was the first to start of this wave of riders. Then it was Port and then Evenepoel. Oh, suffering all over the face of Tage Egenhardt. Remco Evenepoel chasing the time of Hugo Hull of 57 minutes 56.46. He's on to the track now. One full lap and he'll be back to complete his efforts. The national champion of Norway, Tobias Foss.
9 seconds.
Away goes Tobias Foss and our last wave of riders. He's the first of them to leave. 12 riders remain. And Foss, the champion of Norway, is a former under-23 European champion in the time trial. Meanwhile, bobbing and weaving a little bit is Alberto Bertiol in the effort now. Evenepoel on the speedway with 3 kilometers to go. He's got 20 seconds in hand on the man in the hot seat, Canadian Hugo Hull.
It looks like Evenepoel is going to take the fastest time of that second wave of all the riders who have finished at this point. But now, with Foss being the first of the last wave of riders, there are some big names in that last wave.
Tobias Foss is third in the time trial, the opening stage time trial at the Giro, and 12th in the final time trial.
9 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
With George Bennett finished and done and dusted, New Zealand's hopes rest with Patrick Bevan.
The dark horse. He may be up there in medal contention today. Patrick Bevan certainly spent some good time on his time trial bike.
Fourth of the World Championships in 2014. The Tuzia Basque Country's time trial saw him finish in seventh place there, and he was 10th at the Stage 3 time trial at Paris-Nice. His efforts into focusing on this Olympic time trial as Patrick Bevan this year. Evenepoel out to 20 seconds, his advantage now. This is the man most likely to threaten him, Rigoberto Urán. Almost seem to have, there he goes, drifted across the track to maximize every apex of the bend. 31 seconds now, he's eating into Hugo Hull's time.
He's certainly left a little bit in the tank for the last section of this race. We saw him take a little bit of a rest on that last climb, but he's certainly bringing it home. Brendan McNulty now starting for the USA.
2, 1, go.
The 2016 Junior World Champion is on the road, Brendan McNulty. Under 23 bronze medalist in 2019 and silver in 2017. This is a man of real talent and he's in good form as well at the moment, Brendan McNulty. He's a teammate of Tadej Pogacar at the Tour de France when the Slovenian won his second yellow jersey. 11th in that final Tour de France time trial. Evenepoel emptying the tank now as he heads towards the finish, the Belgian. Remember that time of Hugo Ulle, 57 minutes, 56.46 seconds. And Evenepoel has really hammered it over this last sector. Can he finish it off? Still got a bit of work to do. Remco Evenepoel, he's looking likely to take the hot seat in the lead from Hugo Ulle of Canada. The young Belgian, 21 years of age, in his first Olympic time trial, will take the hot seat with a time that is 57 minutes, 21.27 seconds. He is the new leader by 35.19 seconds. Remco Evenepoel of Belgium.
Well, still quite a few riders to come in from that second wave, and also all of the riders from the final wave of riders. But will it be enough to put him into the top five of the Tokyo Olympics? You can see this event is just so grueling. You don't really feel all the pain until you stop, and it is excruciating.
There's nothing quite like it for these riders as we head to the start ramp, and a man who was the silver medalist in Rio de Janeiro 4 years ago. He's the 2017 world champion. He won the silver a year later. He is one of the finest time trialists around, but his current form is a little bit unknown. Tom Dumoulin is on the course. Meanwhile, Theo Gegenhardt is finishing 4:23.54 down. Bettiol, the Italian, number two rider, if you like, because Filippo Ganna, the world champion, still has to go here. But Bettiol is going to put a decent time to bed.
Well, until the last quarter of the race, he was on par with Evenepoel. Just didn't bring it back quite as fast in the end.
And it's the second fastest time.
Not the best day for Richie Porte. Still got Rohan Dennis from Australia to come off in the last wave. He'll be the fifth last rider to hit the course. But not the best day for Richie Porte.
The 10th place at the moment for the Australian. Rigoberto Urán is about to enter the last lap of this course. Now, the Colombian is a serious threat to Remco Evenepoel. Silver medalist on the road in Rio in the road race. And he was eighth in the time trial.
10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Kasper Asgreen, many people, another dark horse, rather like Patrick Bevan. Sixth at the World Championships last year.
And with second place in the final individual time trial at the Tour de France, he's the Danish national champion. He could be a serious contender today. It's wide open. So many favourites and big names still to start. Kasper Asgreen taking those first corners.
And Ronde van Vlaanderen earlier this year as well. Monument to his name. Smoothly through that quite technical start to the route. Tom Dumoulin.
Yeah, big question mark. In January, he decided to take some time off from the sport. He wasn't loving it as much as he used to, so he had a little bit of time off, and we haven't seen much of him this year. until he won the National Time Trial Championship in June. But Tom Dumoulin, he's one of the fan favourites as well. We'll be hoping he has a good ride today.
Meanwhile, Rigoberto Urán is the man chasing Remco Evenepoel's time. And this man has an opportunity to put himself and his country on the podium as well. Primoz Roglic, 2019 Vuelta a España winner, the first Slovenian to win a Grand Tour, and since then Tadej Pogacar has done the job as well, and he's added a second Vuelta to his name, so they really are one of the dominant nations in the Grand Tours. Remco Evenepoel can afford a smile. He's done a grand job, the 21-year-old. Real talent from Belgium. He's put himself in an excellent position, although there's plenty of quality time trialists to come. This is a man who may well challenge him right now.
Well, we saw Evenepoel come back so fast in the last 2 or 3 kilometres. Can Urán match his time? The moment he's slightly faster.
Digging deep, the Colombian. He's he was one of the sort of early of the latest wave of the Colombians to make a real impact on the world tour. Double gold medalist on the track in the men's team pursuit in 2008 and 2012. This is Geraint Thomas on the course.
Well, he's holding that time steady, Urán, against Evenepoel. He'll be getting all of the motivation possible through the race radio. So close to the finish. He has just got to ignore that pain, and he still looks pretty strong. Let's see if he can beat that time of Evenepoel to take the hot seat.
Yeah, he was a silver medalist in the road race in 2012 in London, 9 years ago, when Remco Evenepoel was 12.
12 years old. He's still got a baby face. Oh, Urán has brought it home fast. Let's see. It's coming down to the wire. 300 metres to go. 15 seconds, 14 seconds.
He's on the grid now and out of the saddle. The Colombian Rigoberto Urán. Can he get the better of Remco Evenepoel? It's going to be very close. He does. Into the hot seat goes Rigoberto Urán. 2.58 seconds. Sees the Colombian post a very fine time.
He'll be super happy with that ride. Strong finish. Could see coming up that straight throw for the line. And that's how amazing time trialing is over that distance, that the times can be so close.
So, Evenepoel, a short sit in the chair. And Urán. What an effort by the elder statesman of the latest wave of Colombians. Hopes of Australia for gold at the individual time trial rest on the shoulders of this man, Rohan Dennis.
Well, he's 31 now, and he has put all of his focus into this Olympic Games. He's fired up, he's focused. He skipped the road race to be in top form for this time trial. We're back with Tom Dumoulin and all the big names now starting to get into their rhythm. Tom Dumoulin being one of those riders that spends a lot of time specifically preparing for the time trial, spends a lot of time on his time trial bike. He's got everything dialed in. Silver medal at the last Olympic Games in Rio. And a little bit of confidence will come from the fact that Cancellara, who beat him in Rio, has retired and is not here in Tokyo.
Tom Squids waves as he crosses the line. He's one of the real, I don't say characters, but he's just got a wonderfully engaging personality, and he engages before he even crossed the line there. The Latvian champion does the job, finishes his time trial, and he does so with a smile, I'm sure.
10 seconds.
Remy Kvanja. Away goes the 2020 French time trial champion, Remy Kvanja. Two excellent results at the Giro. He was fifth on stage one's time trial and second on stage 21. He won the stage five time trial at Romandie. Betiol and Uran. Uran in the hot seat with Evenepoel in second place. So Kvanja on the course now. One of those who didn't finish the road race, so doesn't have all that distance in his legs. Patrick Conrad. Now that the Austrian's got a place in the time trial, and he's completed his time trial 15 fastest at the moment. But his year's been made with a stage win at the Tour. Bronze medalist at the World Championships last year. Following in the long line of great time trialists from Switzerland, they already have a medal in the women's time trial, and this is the challenger for a medal. And he's a serious challenger, Stefan Kung. 2020 European champion Kung, as well as Dennis, gets to work. What about mindset with Rohan Dennis, isn't it?
Yeah, it is a lot about mindset with Rohan Dennis. He's a rider that's either on or off, and we believe he's on for this Olympic Games. He's nearly spent his entire season, after not being selected for the Tour de France, just focusing on this Olympic time trial.
Kubis, the youngest rider in the field, a big ask to pitch up here as a replacement for Peter Sagan. But he did the road race, and he's now done the time trial. And that will be another layer of experience in his book of experiences on the, as a World Tour rider.
10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Wout van Aert, second last rider out of the start. The Belgian is the form man. Silver medal in the road race. He won the time trial on the second last day of the Tour de France. He then won the stage on the Champs-Élysées. And many feel this course might be his for the taking. Might have to contend with this man, though, Tom Dumoulin. As Matej Bodnar has put together a very tidy ride. The pole. And he's going to bring it home for Poland. I just heard in the background there the announcement that the last rider is into the start ramp, and here he is. Most consistently high performing time trialist at the moment.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
World champion Filippo Ganna of Italy is onto the course, the last rider in the men's individual time trial, and he heads out to see if he can bring home the gold for Italy.
Well, there's been a question mark about the course. Is it too hilly for Filippo Ganna? Is it more a course for the likes of Rohan Dennis and Tom Dumoulin? Wout van Aert likes those punchy climbs. To me, Dumoulin is looking good so far. He's an emotional rider too, so it's either emotionally on or off. Let's see how his split here compares. 15 seconds faster than Bettiol already. You know, as we know, we saw in the women's race, you have to go out hard in this time trial. You can't be too conservative.
Alexander Vlasov of the Russian Olympic Committee bobbing his head as he digs in the final few meters of his time trial. Brutally tough event, this eighth place at the moment for Vlasov. So all the riders have left the start, not many have finished, and it now is coming down to which of these on the course is going to be able to bring it home for glory and the gold medal.
Tom Dumoulin is looking good. He's looking fast. He's looking relaxed using the road. Everything looks good so far in the early stages of the time trial for Tom Dumoulin.
He was the fastest through that first time. So Patrick Bevan, fourth fastest. Brandon McNulty, seventh fastest of these last tranche of starters. Shuckman bringing it home.
It's the last rider of the second wave, Shuckman.
It's wonderful to see they're allowing the spectators down to trackside, which is good to see, bringing them close to the action as Shuckman finishes his effort as Kasper Asgreen closes in on the first time check.
A little bit off the pace for Asgreen, the first time check.
It's the third fastest time, so it puts into perspective how strong and how well Tom Dumoulin has gone.
Well, he would have had that great atmosphere of Annemiek van Vleuten of the Dutch team winning the women's individual time trial. It just kind of lifts the morale in the team camp. At the moment, Uran is the fastest to finish. Evenepoel just behind. And Alberto Bettiol sitting in third position at this moment.
Oliveira, the Portuguese rider, George Bennett of New Zealand, well, they have hopes with Patrick Bevan.
Well, Patrick Bevan is out on the course. We've not seen a time check, but now we've got Primoz Roglic.
Well, he's going very well indeed, the Slovenian Roglic. Closing in on that time check, he's got the fastest time.
Well, it's his type of course, Roglic. And he's the fastest through that time check. A very good sign for Primoz Roglic.
Yeah, many feel it is his type of course. Is it this man's type of course? This is Filippo Ganna, who has been the utterly dominant in time trials of late on the World Tour. He's won 13 of the last 15 he started.
Well, he's gone out attacking, out of the seat, putting some power through those pedals, just trying to get up to maximum speed as soon as possible. He's got the time trialing. Whoa, look at that bike. Sorry, I was just sidetracked by the colour of that bike. Looks beautiful in different sunlights. Weight not being too much of an issue, so the extra weight of the paint, but that is a special looking bike for Filippo Ganna.
Well, he's a powerful rider on the track, of course, as well, is Ganna. Meanwhile, Wout van Aert is just ahead of him.
The big hopes for Belgium. They really want to be on the podium here.
This man is a supreme all-rounder, triple cyclocross world champion, three stage wins at this year's Tour de France that are quite extraordinary in their variety. Double ascent of Mont Ventoux, he won that stage. He then won the penultimate stage, which is a time trial, and then promptly beat the most successful sprinter in Tour de France history on the most biggest stage of all, at the Champs-Élysées, and the finish line. Geraint Thomas, 26.87 seconds down, the eighth fastest time through that time split. It's been a tough year for him. He had five falls, I think, at the Tour de France. Then he fell again in the Olympic road race here.
And we saw he was in a little bit of pain in that road race when he came off the bike. Didn't finish the road race and pulled out, hoping to come good for the time trial. But it doesn't look like today's going to be the day for Geraint Thomas.
Remy Cavagna. Well, he's going very nicely at the moment. Is the French champion, former French champion. He's not the current time trial champion, but he's a serious rider when it comes to the time trials, Cavagna.
Well, he might have things right today. He's absolutely flying, Cavagna. Looks nice and smooth.
All eyes on Rohan Dennis.
Well, right from the start, he's got some work to do. He's going to get that time check and he's going to know 7 seconds down on Roglic at the first time check. Still a long way to race.
So Roglic and Dumoulin posted faster times than this man at that first time check. It is the big climb. He's got to do this twice, of course. But out overall, virtual leader on the course at the moment, though. Many feel that when he has got something to prove, when there's a little bit of an irritation in him, feels that he needs to vent a little, he will be a danger on these time trials. As Cavagna swings right up the climb now. Going very well indeed. Over half a minute up on the man in the hot seat's time at the moment.
Yeah, we're getting those time checks versus Iran. But a lot of the riders out on the road are between 10 to 30 seconds up on the time of Iran.
Roglic's time is standing up that first time split. And report that Tom Dumoulin has gone through the second time split at 15 kilometres faster than anyone. 19 seconds faster than the next best, Kas Vasgren. So Dumoulin looks in some very tidy form. Big question marks as to how strong he would be at this time trial, having missed so much of the year. Optional decision. He just decided to step away from the Tour. It had got a little too much for him.
Yeah, interestingly, we don't hear about the mental struggles so much in men's cycling as we do in the women's cycling. They seem to be a little bit more open about that type of thing. But Tom Dumoulin, he did express that he was losing a little bit of passion and motivation earlier in the year, but certainly came back with great form to win the national TT title. As we're back with Filippo Ganna, is the course too tough for him? No, at this point he is absolutely flying.
Let's say it is a very special looking machine. That is a time trial bike.
Yeah, first time we've seen that colour for a bike of Filippo Ganna, and it looks absolutely beautiful as we are with Kung, Stefan Kung, coming into this time check. 9 seconds behind Roglic's time check.
Well, he was a real contender at the Tour de France time trials, fourth in the final time trial, second in the early time trial.
Tom Dumoulin, he looks like he's on it today. keeping the speed high, very, very smooth.
He is absolutely superb.
You can see he's riding slightly deeper front dish wheel, all the nice black. Looks the goods, Tom Dumoulin.
Tobias Foss, the Norwegian champion. This is at the halfway split, measuring him against Hugo Hull at that stage. Hull was the fastest. Remke Evenepoel then came home. And, of course, Rigoberto Urán. And he goes through just ahead of Richie Port's time there. Bart van Aert, the second last rider to pass through this position, and he's down by over 4 seconds on Primoz Roglic's time.
Well, 4 seconds, it's not really a lot that early in the race through the first time check, as Paddy Bevin just comes in for the halfway mark. 6 seconds quicker than Hula.
Well, he's done the first half well, as Patrick Bevan. Work to do on the second. Big focus for him this year, the Olympic time trial for Bevan. Forgone most other commitments in order to focus on preparing for this and getting it all right on the day. And so far, it's looking good.
Back with the current world champion, Filippo Ganna. Just puts it into a small gear as he hits this steep section of the climb.
So this is where the testing starts for Ganna. He did so much work for his trade team at the Giro on the front. Day after day after day. And since then, it's been focused, and look at that. He's absolutely hammered it through the first time split. So, Filippo Ganna is the man everyone's looking at now.
Early stages of this time trial, but Filippo Ganna on that special painted bike, he is flying out of the gun. Long way to go yet. Filippo Ganna, we hear from the sidelines. He has some fans out there.
Fans bringing riders through the start finish. Brandon McNulty. And behind him, there's McNulty. Across the line, 42.81 seconds down on the fastest time through there. And Tom Dumoulin goes 40 seconds faster. It's no real surprise. We've seen some form from him today that suggests that the Dutchman might just be in the type of form that could see him post a medal-winning time today. Whether it'll be gold, silver, or bronze remains to be seen. But he's showing some excellent form.
The indication he'll be getting from the radio, the team car, the motivation at those time splits are all important to keep the morale high.
Well, his fifth place finish at the Tour de Suisse time trial suggested that he'd spent some of that time to take it off as a break from the sport, just putting in a little bit of work, that's for sure. He won the Dutch time trial championship, something he's done four times. But this is a different kettle of fish to move from silver to gold, perhaps, for Tom Dumoulin, having taken silver in Rio.
Well, it's going to be a very positive thing, and morale lifting that he's catching another rider. It could be Paddy Bevin of New Zealand.
He He is looking in such good form, is Tom Dumoulin. Also a man who is able to win on so many different different terrain. It's Brandon McNulty he's going to be getting past now.
Yeah, the rider that just started in front of him, so that's one rider. Little bit of a messy takeover there, but it could have benefited Tom Dumoulin to just slipping through seconds in that slipstream.
His 92nd man, he was thought ahead of him. That can't do much for young Brandon McNulty's morale when he sees Tom Dumoulin go past him. Mind you, it is Tom Dumoulin. He'll be saying, well, I sort of expected that. This is a man who has won the world championship. In fact, he's got all three medals from the world championship over the years, says Dumoulin. Jean Maeda closing in on the halfway point of this ride, and he's a little down, the Portuguese champion. Well, Tom Dumoulin's time at the halfway split was so devastatingly fast that anyone else at the moment who's putting in what they think is a really good time is going to look a little bit off pace. Asgreen. Making time all the while to Tom Dumoulin's time. Will be probably inside Paddy Bevan's time.
This goes to show how fast Tom Dumoulin was. For Asgreen to come through, 37 seconds slower, but in second position at the moment.
Primoz Roglic. Here we go. This is the race starting to unfold as we head to the heading to the second half of the time trial. The seconds dropping off all the time as Roglic drives for the halfway point. And he may well post the fastest time. He does. 8.39 seconds faster, Dumoulin, at halfway. So, 22 kilometres for him to keep that going. He'll know that the challengers behind him are going to be posting quick times as well. Geraint Thomas might not be, Rohan Dennis, Cavagna there and thereabouts, Kung van Aert and Ghana. But he's done what he can at halfway.
A very impressive halfway split for Roglic, fastest at the halfway point. No signs of tiring, looks like he's in control. Very powerful, very comfortable on his time trial bike. Time to straighten up the helmet.
Tricky time trial bikes, I don't want to get it wrong on these corners. Out onto the open road now is Roglic. He's a minute up on the man in the hot seat, Rigoberto Urán. At that stage, Rohan Dennis. The hopes of Australia rest on this man. He was fifth in Rio, despite the fact that he had to change a bike due to a broken ski. But that would have motivated him tremendously to redress that and seek some redemption here in Tokyo. Emotional rider. An immensely powerful. Rohan Dennis, world champion 2 years in a row, 2018 and 2019. He was fifth last year. And Geraint Thomas. It's been a tough all year for this man.
Yeah, it certainly has been, and it is showing today.
2018 Tour de France champion, Geraint Thomas, already a gold medalist, of course, at the Olympic Games on the track. What an utterly dominant team pursuit team, 2008 and 2012, as Rohan Dennis closes in. I don't think he'll be able to get inside Roglic's halfway split time.
No, he's definitely going to have to pick up the pace if he wants to be in the gold medal contention here in Tokyo. So not a massive time difference, but still a lot of work if he wants to bring it home. He does tend to bring it home quite well in the championships, but 9 seconds behind Roglic at the halfway mark.
Yeah, it's all you feel about that big match temperament on a day like this. There's nothing much bigger than the Olympic Games. And who can control the emotions, control their efforts, manage their expectations and their output to the very best and bring home the gold medal? Rémi Cavagna is doing all he can, the Frenchman. He went through split two in seventh fastest time, 12.30 seconds behind the fastest, Primoz Roglic. As Wout van Aert gets to the task here, second fastest at the second split.
You can see he's carrying his radio in his front of his skin suit, in his chest, rather than where most of the riders are carrying it, between their shoulder blades on their back. Cavagna coming in for the halfway time check.
He was 12 seconds off the pace at the 15 kilometer mark. And he's losing a bit of time now. Rémi Cavagna, France, rolling over the start-finish line for the first time. 53.16 seconds down in fourth fastest time at that stage of the ride. Nothing spared, putting it all out there, Cavagna. Wout van Aert said he went through second fastest, 0.04 of a second, at the first intermediate split, 15 Ks. That's how tight it's going to be. It's going to come down to fractions of a second, you feel, in this time trial.
Certainly it's going to be a close one. It's going to come down to the wire in the second half of this lap, and so much can change in the second half as we see Stefan Kung just coming up to the halfway mark.
Kung made up time between the two checkpoints. How's he going here? Well, he is 15.59 of a second behind Primoz Roglic's time at that stage. Well, he does so much work in all the races he rides. He's an attacking rider. He's a rider of flair. He tried all he could in the road race to Wout van Aert, but the group he was in, of course, didn't want to do anything, because they knew if they took him to the line, then he would win, he but the most likely chance to win because of his power on the sprint. But of course, Richard Carapaz took advantage of the hesitation and attacked and went up the road to win the gold medal in the road race. And Wout van Aert won the sprint just ahead of Pogacar to take the silver. Slovenian was the bronze medalist. He is an outright favorite for a medal. Question is, which will it be? We won't be able to better the time of Primoz Roglic. Nor that of Tom Dumoulin or Stefan Kung. So Van Aert's got work to do on the second half. It's going to be a fascinating last sector of this time trial.
And I think Van Aert will bring home a little bit more speed in the second lap. But at the moment, fourth at the halfway mark. Looking good for Roglic. Can he hold the speed through the second half? And now we see the world champion Filippo Ganna.
Just hitches back up to the back of the saddle as he puts the maximum effort in here, heading towards the halfway intermediate time split. Beautiful position on the bike, Ganna. Many, many hours in the velodrome, the wind tunnels, and getting that position absolutely dialed in.
Well, it looks like he's going to be just off the time of Roglic as well. The last rider to cross the halfway mark in this Olympic Games.
Will be second fastest, third fastest, so Ganna. Final sector for him. The fastest rider across was Primoz Roglic at the halfway split. Ganna, third fastest. The world champion has his work cut out today. He's been utterly dominant in time trials. Elsewhere, lost just twice in his last 15 time trials. As we look down on the motor speedway to have a look at those halfway splits, confirming Primoz Roglic the fastest thus far. Tom Dawes the fastest out there. Tom Dumoulin, Filippo Ganna, Rohan Dennis. Wout van Aert 10 seconds is plenty for the Belgian to do to get into the medals.
Well, only 10 seconds at the halfway mark between this man, Roglic, and five riders within 10 seconds. So it's all going to come down to this final lap. Roglic in the zone. He will know he was the fastest through the halfway mark, and that is motivating. He looks solid. He looks solid and powerful on the bike. As we know, a former ski jumper coming across to the sport of cycling.
Yeah, double Grand Tour winner. Heartbreak at last year's final time trial at the Tour de France when it all unraveled rather spectacularly for him and Tadej Pogacar put in the ride of his life to win that individual time trial and ride into the Champs-Élysées in the yellow jersey that this man had worn for days and days ahead of that final stage. And it didn't go well for him this year at the Tour either. So there's some form of redemption for Primoz Roglic at this event.
Tom Dumoulin, he just looks so good on the bike. He looks fast and powerful. Just 8 seconds behind Roglic at the halfway mark. Can he bring it home? he's not riding with a bottle on his bike. We've talked a lot about the aerodynamics, and this man, he would have spent a lot of time in the wind tunnel, Tom Dumoulin. He's got the sock height to the limit.
He is looking in supreme form at the moment, Tom Dumoulin. Whether it brings him gold, silver or bronze, I'm not sure, but having not seen a great deal of him this year, it's wonderful to see the Dutchman, who's one of the most engaging of the top-end World Tour riders. Good to see him in such good form.
Well, this is going to be a very exciting final half of the men's Olympic time trial here in Tokyo. We've got five riders within 10 seconds of each other. Can't afford to make any mistakes, have to get every single line right, take the shortest route possible. And Tom Dumoulin is a master at that. And back to Ghana.
This is the man who won the World Championship last year on home turf in Imola.
Very high cadence there. Clicks down a gear.
Brutal strength and power in those legs for Ghana.
We've seen most of the time trial bikes carrying an aero bottle, but he's got the traditional round bottle on his bike. Beautiful sock height as well. Roglic here just closing in on Kasper Asgreen.
Yeah, Roglic had that nasty crash on stage two of the Tour de France, managed to ride a few more stages, but and pulled out. He finished seventh in the first time trial, but then pulled out after stage nine, and he breezes past Kasper Asgreen. Primoz Roglic.
But he looked powerful, didn't he? He looked punchy on that climb. Doesn't look like he's tiring at all. If you compare his form to Asgreen, he is absolutely pumping it out on this course.
Yeah, Primoz Roglic. Not having that this time, is he?
Can't be good when a rider passes you like that with that much power. You can see how well Roglic has studied this course. He stayed right out on the left to take this right-hand corner. Taking all the right lines, seems to be in control. Kasper Asgreen tries to keep him within distance, knowing that Roglic is on a good time. If he can stay close behind, as we switch over to Tom Dumoulin. Well, he is flying.
He's at this stage holding a very handy advantage over the man in the hot seat. That's just basing on Tom Dumoulin's time here, but he is looking in great form. Roglic, though, has posted the fastest time at split four, so he is the man. Just discards what looked like a bar.
Yeah, he's decided he won't need to take on that nutrition between now and the finish line. He wants comfort, he wants aerodynamics, and he wants to keep that speed high.
Empty the tank, and just under 10 minutes remaining in the effort for Tom Dumoulin. It's the race of truth. There's nowhere to hide in the time trial. Brutally hard discipline. Some will say the hardest in the sport of cycling.
Oh, right on the tip of his saddle. That's what we see towards the end of the races. And this is just the replay of discarding whatever food he had.
Yep. Not prepared to carry anything extra. This little drag up to the course. The legs will be suffering, burning, aching. But it's the mental strength that is the most powerful weapon for these riders. Absolutely ruthless in banishing any thoughts of pain and failure. As Rohan Dennis
past Geraint Thomas.
Geraint Thomas, yeah.
But he doesn't look his normal self, Rohan Dennis. His aggressive type of riding. The shoulders are moving for Rohan Dennis. Roglic.
He is just in awesome form as well, Primoz Roglic.
Closes in on Casper Asgreen. The course certainly does suit Primoz Roglic. So there's been passing and passing and passing.
Asgreen retook him after we'd seen him slip back a little. He's found a second wind. He's a big man, isn't he? A powerful unit on these flatter sections, so he's used that to his advantage. Or is it that this man may have gone out too strong? Stop pedaling there to replace his bottle. A 44 kilometer time trial like this really does test everything. There's one lap, go absolutely full gas and empty yourself, but you cannot do that over 44 kilometers, the two laps. Pacing is key, and Casper Asgreen's disappeared up the road.
Yeah, and we're seeing a lot of resting there from Roglic. He likes the punchy climbs, and that's where he's going to try and take his time back. He's still...
Remember, Asgreen did start 90 seconds ahead of him, so although he looks as though he's just a few seconds up the road, that's deceiving.
Now, it might not be a bad thing for Roglic to have a rider in front of him. He certainly did lose a little bit of time to Asgreen. Not in the overall standings, obviously. He's up on Asgreen, but seems to be tiring a little bit, or not have paced himself as well as he'd hoped, but still looks strong to me.
Yeah, he does. He's got this little drag up to the racetrack. Up ahead, Tom Dumoulin is on the track. Well, he's got faster and faster around the course as Tom Dumoulin looked super smooth and in great condition, the Dutchman.
Roglic just using these short, punchy little climbs to take more of an advantage. He's the man to beat at the last time check.
Man ahead of him is João Almeida, the Portuguese champion.
It might have been a little bit of tactical decision to let Asgreen zoom past him when he took a little bit of a break. Now he's got these two riders to chase and pass. Most of the time being gained or lost on the climbs rather than the flat downhill sections. Roglic now powering past Almeida and chasing down Casper Asgreen.
Well, now he will retake Casper Asgreen. He's more at home on the flatter rolling than the climbs.
Yeah, the bigger build of Asgreen, he really used that to his advantage on the faster downhill section. And now he's just using Roglic there, passing again on the flatter section. Not a bad thing for Roglic. Back with Filippo Ganna, the time trial specialist.
Yeah, this is his real speciality as the world time trial champion, and man with a huge engine. Look at these three riders. You don't often see this on a time trial. But the man on the far right, João Almeida. Almeida is almost 3.5 minutes down on Roglic, who is about a minute and a half ahead of Asgreen. As Wout van Aert is bobbing and digging and putting everything in to his effort here.
One of them.
He's losing time, the Belgian.
You have to ask how much the Tour de France and the Olympic road race has taken out of Wout van Aert. But he was absolutely sensational in the road race, taking the silver medal, but having so much pressure to close down all of the breaks until Carapaz was the one that got away and took the gold medal. Wout van Aert taking the silver.
Paddy Bevan takes his bike across the line, finishes the time trial. And Bevan's time of 57 minutes, 24.29 seconds at the moment puts him in third place. Hugo Hull's early time. Remember, he started seventh this morning in the race, and it still stands up in fifth place at the moment.
Just seen Stefan Kung take over Cavagna out on the road.
Tobias Foss, the Norwegian champion, he rolls in towards the finish line, putting every effort in. A little glance up, there's the line. And he will finish 2:32.99 down. Not, he would feel, perhaps, what he was looking for and hoping for.
Well, that's the unique thing about the Olympic Games. You have to be on fire on one day in 4 years. Primoz Roglic may have got it right. He has been absolutely flying. You can see he's pulled away from the other two riders now. It's all or nothing as Tom Dumoulin comes into the finish line.
This is Tom Dumoulin putting the finishing touches to his time trial. A silver medalist last time at Rio de Janeiro. And he has put aside all other aspects of his life to concentrate on this time trial. And he goes fastest. 1 minute 13.11 seconds faster than Rigoberto Urán's time. A phenomenal ride by the Dutchman. 56 minutes, 5.58 seconds. And he's put it all out there for the Netherlands, Tom Dumoulin.
Yeah, he looked good. He looked strong the whole way throughout the race. He's just got that experience in time trialing to pace himself well and stay strong right from the start through to the finish for the Netherlands. They've got one gold medal already today in the women's individual time trial. Now it's a waiting game to see where Tom Dumoulin will finish in the men's individual time trial.
One of those contenders to his position in the hot seat. Rohan Dennis is looking as though he's starting to make up time. This is Geraint Thomas. He's certainly not going to threaten that position. He's had a better second half of the ride, that's for sure.
Oh, Ganna still looks fast. He's moving a little bit around on the saddle, but he's still keeping that pace very high. There's not much in it between Ganna and Dumoulin.
Third fastest through the last checkpoint, Philippe Ganna. Wout van Aert is the other real contender here for Belgians, although he has had a tougher last sector.
Well, and the last month has been so demanding. He's had so many big results and good races, and it has taken its toll. 36 seconds down on Tom Dumoulin's ride. That'll give Tom Dumoulin some confidence.
Yeah, we've made allusions to that, the effort and the hard contrasting Tom Dumoulin and Wout van Aert's years have been. As Brandon McNulty, a young American, and there are a whole lot of wonderful talents coming out of the United States. Zipkus, the stage winner at the Tour de France, Brandon McNulty here, really, really coming to the fore. But he will have, I'm sure, plenty more opportunities to prove himself against in this sort of company. Roglic at the moment up on Dumoulin as he is closing in on the finish. What a ride by the Slovenian.
Absolutely sensational ride by Roglic.
Primoz Roglic is really powering on to the finish here, emptying his tank. He's passed two riders who started ahead of him, and the clock is in his favour at the moment, the Slovenian. A really tough Tour de France, had a crash and had to abandon, had to recover from those injuries, and has come to the Olympic Games in peak condition, and Primoz Roglic is going to go fastest in an amazing time. That is phenomenal riding, 55 minutes, 4.19 is going to be the time. Wow, he is on fire. Roglic in the hot seat.
Well, that's certainly making a point, taking the hot seat by that much time over Tom Dumoulin. It's going to be extremely hard for anyone to beat. Primoz Roglic in form on the day has set a blistering fast time in the men's individual time trial.
Well, the Slovenian is right now in virtual gold medal position. Tom Dumoulin, 1 minute, 1.39 seconds down. Kasper Asgreen, 1:48 in third place right now. Ghana Kung Dennis Van Aert. This is Van Aert, and it doesn't look like it's going to be his day.
No, he's off the pace, Van Aert. So disappointment for the Belgians. They would have been expecting a little bit more, but it's a big ask for a man that's done so much in the last month in cycling. Finally taking its toll.
Well, there isn't a race that he goes to where he just is riding in the bunch and content to finish. He wants to be aggressive. He wants to do his part, win, help a teammate win, whatever it might be. Filippo Ganna also in the red, a moment against Primoz Roglic's time.
Yeah, it looks very convincing from Roglic and Dumoulin for the gold and silver.
Can Rohan Dennis bring it home, maybe? He'll have to do the last 5Ks of his life, but you never know when he's inspired.
Huh? The tough part about time trialing is waiting for the other riders to come in.
Well, he has put in an enormous effort here, Primoz Roglic. From the start, he was knocking seconds out of all the early times. And having had a really tough Tour de France and his team's hopes of a general classification win there were gone, and it did allow Wout van Aert to step into the spotlight, of course. Rohan Dennis. Has he got anything left to find his way onto the podium at least here, Rohan Dennis? And Stefan Kung. The Swiss has had some great results this year. Bronze medalist last year at the World Championship. But this year, second at the early time trial of the Tour de France. Fourth on the last time trial. He won the Tour de Swiss time trial as well. Sort of pedigree on the road. Dennis into the last couple of hundred meters for Australia's Rohan Dennis. Well, he's behind on Roglic's time. Remember, Dumoulin, a minute and one behind Roglic. So that place on the podium is a begging there for Rohan Dennis. Can he get inside it and get himself onto the podium? No, he can't. Well, at the moment, he's in bronze medal position, only just ahead of Kasper Asgreen, as Geraint Thomas finishes 2:42.42 down.
Oh, so close, the time of Rohan Dennis with Tom Dumoulin. But Roglic, what a sensational ride. I can't see that being beaten.
Roglic's time, well, a minute ahead of Tom Dumoulin is quite astounding. Absolutely astonishing ride by Primoz Roglic. Wout van Aert, it's not going to be happening for this man today.
No, certainly not a bad ride, but certainly not close to his best. And we're all wondering how long he could hold on to his form as we see Philip Ganna at the moment.
He's
close to the time of Dumoulin, but he's got to bring it home pretty strong.
Yeah, I mean, it's all about who can get silver and bronze here, because Roglic, yeah.
It looks like he realises he's had an absolutely sensational ride. It's not going to be beaten. Roglic is going to be the man.
Well, teammates, of course, in their trade team, and well, they know each other very, very well. They are regulars alongside one another, although, as we said, Dumoulin spent a lot of time this year off the bike, or away from the tour, so to speak. The way he rode today suggests he might have spent a little bit of time doing some riding. This is Stefan Kung of Switzerland.
It's going to be close for the silver and bronze medals.
Well, Kung has had a really good ride through on the track. Now, can he convert that to a medal and emulate Cancellara as a medalist at least? He's going to be down on Roglic. His goal, though, is Dumoulin's time, and that of Rohan Dennis. And Stefan Kung is going to be so close, and he's just outside the time of Rohan Dennis by 3 hundredths of a second.
Tom Dumoulin sits there in silver medal position at the moment. Roglic in the middle, and Dennis still with the third fastest time. But we still have, well, Van Aert a bit off the pace, but what can Filippo Ganna do?
Remy Cavagna. Well, the Frenchman's had a torrid time out there today. He started today fourth last, but it has not gone his way. And he will finish well down the standings. Based on his start position, he'll be disappointed with the way it's turned out, unless there was an issue out there for the Frenchman that played a role in him finishing at the moment well over 3.5 minutes down on the gold medal position, which surely now is in the hands of Primoz Roglic.
Well, it looks like it's all come together on the day for Roglic. The course suited him. The form was there. He woke up ready to take this Olympic gold medal. And as we still have a few riders, two riders to come in, it looks like the gold medal is going to go to Primoz Roglic. Sensational down the bike.
Wout van Aert puts everything into his last 500 meters or so here at Tokyo. But it's not going to be a medal for the Belgian today. He's achieved so much this year and put so much effort into all he does on the bike, but perhaps that has ultimately cost him in the race of truth at the Olympic Games.
So one more rider out on the course that could potentially ride into the medals. That is Filippo Ganna of Italy. Can he better the time of Tom Dumoulin and Rohan Dennis for a silver medal?
Well, Van Aert, silver in the road race. And that was, again, another example of his aggressive attacking approach. Albeit that Richard Carapaz rode away from the group and managed to keep the gap. Van Aert did so much of the work. Here is Filippo Ganna. Can he get onto the podium? Tom Dumoulin is the time he is chasing. 56.05.58. 56.08.09 is the bronze medal position held at the moment by Rohan Dennis of Australia. Ganna, the world champion. It's not going to be gold for the Italian today. Will it be silver? Will it be bronze? Here he is. The Italian Ganna is going to cross the line now and finish in fifth place. And it is gold for Primoz Roglic, silver for Tom Dumoulin, and bronze for Rohan Dennis of Australia.
Well, we saw some exceptional riding out there today as we just see Ganna come in. As we said, the course might have been just a little bit too hilly for Filippo Ganna. Put him on a flat course, different story. But the Italian will have to settle for fifth place today.
Huge effort by the big man from Italy, Filippo Ganna. And it is this man, Primoz Roglic, is the Olympic champion. The Slovenian has put it all together on the day and ridden the time trial of his life. Incredible. The time gap to second place, 1 minute 39 seconds, 1 minute 1 second, beg your pardon. Absolutely amazing. And that is a tribute to Roglic's dedication to getting it right here in the time trial. Perhaps not finishing the Tour de France worked in his favor. The three medalists, well, between them, just 9 Tour de France stages this year.
Primoz Roglic. Tom Dumoulin looks happy with his silver medal after a tough year. Rohan Dennis maybe a little bit disappointed. Really wanted to win the gold here, but this man was unbeatable on the day. One of the biggest margins we'll see an Olympic time trial won by Primoz Roglic. Everything came together on the day.
A quite astonishing ride in the time trial by Primoz Roglic of Slovenia. He set off as the 7th last rider, Roglic, and just chipped away through every of those time splits. Tom Dumoulin, a silver medalist for the 2nd games in a row. Emotion for a man who wears his heart on his sleeve. And feels that those are tears of happiness, because he knows that he was beaten, well beaten, by this man today. A reflective Primoz Roglic, the gold medalist.
Yeah, may not have quite sunk in just yet.
And here's the bronze medalist, Rohan Dennis. Gold was his goal, but he's being sent from pillar to post at the moment. I think he's got to go get back on the hot seat. No. So, Dumoulin silver for the 2nd games in a row.
And will that be enough to inspire him to stay in cycling? He said after the Olympic Games he was going to consider what the next few years hold for him, whether he was going to continue on the same path, find a new challenge, or retire altogether from cycling. Tom Dumoulin, silver medalist here at the Tokyo Olympic Games in the individual time trial.
Bronze medal for Rohan Dennis of Australia today. Putting it all out there. Dennis, he started 5th last today, and it just didn't quite fall for him. It wasn't for lack of effort, though.
No, I'm sure he can be happy with his effort, because he put everything into it on the day, and it was just enough to win the bronze medal. And Tom Dumoulin, he also had a near-perfect ride. It was just the better man on the day, Primoz Roglic, that no one could even come near in the time trial.
Yeah, he did very little wrong today. He looked in great position. The silver medalist from Rio makes it to back-to-back silver medals, Tom Dumoulin. But the man standing head and shoulders above all others today, seventh last out of the start hut, it was Primoz Roglic, the Slovenian, who put together the ride of his life in this very tough 44.2-kilometer course in Tokyo to post a time of a minute, 1 second faster than Tom Dumoulin. 55 minutes, 4.19 seconds. A quite astonishing ride by the Slovenian. Gold to Slovenia, silver to Netherlands, and bronze to Australia. Great teammates. Wout van Aert congratulating Primoz Roglic.
Točno tako smo rekli. Ovinke sem šel prepočasno, ampak nisem upal hitrejši. Večno nisem. Na varno.
Confirming the results of the men's individual time trial at the on Fuji Speedway. Primoz Roglic, 55 minutes 04.19 seconds. The winner of the gold medal ahead of Tom Dumoulin by 1 minute 1.39 and Rohan Dennis of Australia taking the bronze medal. Stefan Kung just missing out and Philippe Pogano, the world champion, in fifth place. Fine ride, Balbetta, Bettiol. Stefan de Bot of South Africa, one of the early starters behind Hugo Hull. 13th and 14th, their time stood up very well indeed, having started very early on in the piece. Tobias Fosse, Norwegian champion, will be a little bit disappointed the way things went for him. Brandon McNulty, a promising ride from the young Australian, the American, more to come from him. George Bennett, the climber, would have had an experience riding today. Leon Izaguirre, the only non-finisher, with what looked like cramps. That's the way it unfolded here at the Mount Fuji Speedway in the men's individual time trial. The men's individual time trial, the last of the road events at the Tokyo Olympic Games. And Tom Dumoulin, the Dutchman, was an early pace setter today, setting a cracking time, the fastest halfway split at that time. The man had started 10th last today, and he was in great form, the Dutchman, to cross the line and move Rigoberto Urán off the podium position at that stage. Starting three places after him was Primoz Roglic, the Slovenian, who'd had a frustrating Tour de France and had to withdraw after nine stages due to the injuries from a crash. He's recovered, and he put together the ride of the day. 8.39 seconds faster than Dumoulin at the halfway split. He caught his 92nd man, Kasper Asgreen, and eventually posted a time of phenomenal 54 minutes, 4.19 seconds. Over a minute faster than Dumoulin at that stage. Rohan Dennis was fifth last to start, the Australian and former two-time world champion. And he came through the halfway split in third place there, and he managed to hold that good all the way through to the finish to take third overall and the bronze medal for Australia. Roglic, Dumoulin and Dennis. time for the victory ceremony for the men's individual time trial at the Mount Fuji Speedway, the venue for the final event on the road race program at Tokyo's Summer Olympics 2020.
Veuillez accueillir les médaillés.
Please welcome the medalists.
Medalist, お迎えください.
The medalists in the men's individual time trial make their way out onto the track to be presented with their hard-earned medals. Tom Dumoulin, silver medalist. Behind him, Primoz Roglic of Slovenia, the gold medalist. And Australia's Rohan Dennis, the bronze medalist. Huge physical effort, immense emotional effort as well. And ultimately, these three riders, the top three in a field of 39.
Monsieur Ivo Ferriani, membre de la commission exécutive du CIO Italie, Olympien.
IOC Executive Board Member, Italy, Olympia.
IOC Rigi, Italia, Olympia.
Accompagné par...
Accompanied by...
続きまして...
Monsieur Tom Van Damme, membre du comité de gestion de l'UCI Belgique.
UCI Management Committee Member, Belgium.
UCI, UAE, Belgium.
Médaille de bronze, Australie.
Bronze medalist, Australia.
Gold medalist, Australia. Rohan Dennis.
Well, not since Michael Rogers took the bronze medal in 2004 in Athens has an Australian stepped onto the podium, and Rohan Dennis collects the bronze medal. He is a silver medalist in the team pursuit in the track in London in 2012. And joins Cathy Watt as the only Australian cyclist to become a multiple medalist or medalist in the track and the road.
Médaille d'argent, Pays-Bas.
Silver medalist, Netherlands.
Gold medalist, Hollande. Tom Dumoulin.
Well, he's had a tough year, Tom Dumoulin. He stepped away from the sport for a long period at the start of the year and has come back to take his second consecutive silver medal. And joins Fabian Cancellara, Vyacheslav Ekimov and Chris Froome as the only riders to have won more than one medal in the time trial.
Médaille d'or et champion olympique, Slovénie.
Gold medalist and Olympic champion, Slovenia.
金メダリスト, Olympic champion, Slovenia. Primoz Roglic.
It was a ride for the ages today by this man, Primoz Roglic. A minute and 1 second faster than his closest rival. He was utterly dominant.
Strong race.
Certainly was a strong race. Gold medalist in the individual time trial. Primoz Roglic, the first medalist on the road from his country of Slovenia.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la Slovénie.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of Slovenia.
皆様、スロベニア国歌の演奏です。
Slovenian anthem heard for the first time at the road events in Olympic history. And the man to bring them glory, Primoz Roglic, with a ride that really was quite astonishing. Primoz Roglic, the gold medalist in the men's individual time trial. Tom Dumoulin taking the silver medal. And Australia's Rohan Dennis, the bronze medal. Trade teammates Dumoulin and Roglic. Primoz Roglic collects a precious gold medal, the first Slovenian to do so at these Olympic Games. On the road, he takes the individual men's time trial in a dominant performance, with Tom Dumoulin taking the silver medal, and in the bronze medal position, Australia's Rohan Dennis.